please work, please, oh my god, work. Oh, it's working. Let me move you a bit because you are loud as fuck. Okay, let me share this to Shizu before I start playing Minecraft and you start explaining. Wait, how do I? Yeah, that's how you copy a link. I'm smart. I know what I'm doing.
Yeah? Are you sure?
I know what I'm doing.
I'm not sure.
Fuck you. I think you're gonna like the title I chose.
Oh no. Am I gonna be worried?
50-50 chance.
That's not comforting.
Sends it to Shizu. I need to pull up the stream on my phone so I know what she's saying, because I'm a dumb bitch.
It'll probably be like us picking on you.
Okay, wait. Call audio up. It's media audio. My media audio is down. Got it. Yes, I know how my phone works.
I'm sure.
I'm not old like you.
And yet, I'm more technologically advanced than you.
Fuck you.
Like that, bitch.
Wait. Have you ever tried to lower the call volume while you're on an Instagram call and does not lower?
No.
It does lower. Okay, I'm dumb. Never mind.
Look, it's becoming really hard to defend you.
Look, listen here. I know what I'm doing. Don't moan on my stream. You're gonna get me. You're gonna get me. You're gonna get me age restricted.
To what age exactly?
I don't fucking know. It says one person's watching me, but I don't know if that's you or me.
Well, I haven't started watching
you yet. So. Well, my thing just says stream will start in a moment. I'm very proud of all my minimalistic art, except this one. The hand looks really crooked because there was wands in front of it. There wasn't much I could do.
Incorrect. Well, what the fuck's my password then? Well, obviously not that.
Your password is the first verse to We Don't Talk About Bruno.
Oh, yeah. How could I possibly forget such a thing?
He's hacking the internet, boys.
It's the first verse of We Don't Talk About Bruno, but my keyboard's fucked, so we'll be here for a long time.
Would you like me to sing it for you to help you? I'm not singing the goddamn song.
It's like dictation. You sing all the time.
Waiting on a miracle is what gets in my head.
Really? Fuck yeah. We don't talk about Bruno, we won't stay out of my fucking head.
I love waiting on a miracle.
That's because you have trauma.
Yeah, what about you then?
Well, we don't talk about Bruno because I'm the family outcast.
Okay, fair enough. My foot's already falling asleep. I need to... I have a be back in a bit minimalistic art, but I should probably make one for hold on a sec, because be back in a bit is... when I'm not sitting here. So I should make one for when I'm just sitting here and being a dumbass. Or changing screens or something. Because technical difficulties is for when I'm being a dumbass.
Oh yeah, your stream isn't even showing up.
Well, I'm waiting for she's it because I don't want you to start explaining while we wait. Well, while we wait, I'm just gonna. We're doing this in my personal world. So I can show off my somewhat good skills.
Now we don't talk about Bruno's in my fucking head.
No, it's loading.
What is?
Minecraft.
Minecraft? Oh.
Yeah, I'm getting into the world at least so I can play. And it's on stream, you can watch.
Refresh the page. Pick up. Yeah, you're still not coming up.
Really? It's up on my phone, so it's definitely working.
Why is
Are you looking at the right thing?
that? Well, I'm looking at your YouTube.
Okay. Want me to send you the link? And you say I'm bad at the internet.
It's not my fault the internet's not working.
That is.
I know what to do. Okay, not actually. No, I'm not Jess. That's not my name either. That's my name. Log me in, bitch.
I'm just waiting for you on the game menu because I don't. I, you know, no, I'm gonna start playing. It's just fucking lag. Jesus Christ. I need to wait for it to not lag. And I probably should put my headphones in so I know what the fuck I'm listening to.
Ah, Hoshikuse
Yeah, that's what I did. I decided that's what this will be.
Air-lies. Anything to do with me is just Hoshikuse
If it's just me playing a game and you explain and talking some bullshit, then yeah. This lag is gonna kill me. Is there a way to make it not lag? Probably, but I'm not good at this.
He doesn't do technology, guys.
I guess I do. Maybe I should have turned on the render distance. I probably should do that.
Maybe. I don't know if it'll work, but I don't stream. And I play Minecraft on a Switch.
Is this any better? Please be better. Okay, that's slightly better. It was the goddamn render distance. It's Anyway, I'm trying to think. Oh, would you
Because
like
I
to see
have
my
nothing
collection
to
of
do.
llamas?
I would love to see your collection of llamas.
Why is the goddamn gate open? Oh yeah, I moved my horse.
I forgot how delayed.
It is, yeah, I'm sorry. No, that's just how streams work. I did learn that. It's not me lagging or anything. God, the lag though. The llamas are killing me.
You got too many llamas.
Llamas. I'm gonna wait till the stream catches up.
That's a lot of llamas.
Oh, I guess it caught up.
Why are you collecting llamas, Kelly?
They're all trader llamas.
Oh my
I
God.
kill the trader once I'm done trading, and then take the llamas into this pen.
But like the minute you hurt the traitor, they like spit at you because they're assholes.
Yes, but I'm not dumb anymore. Also, once you put it on lead again, it stops spinning.
Oh, okay. I didn't actually know that.
I also now have a horse.
Mainly because I don't steal llamas.
I am an animal connoisseur, and I shall show you, because I have an animal room. Two parrots. I do have four parrots, so the other two parrots are at the other house. And then fish, because I've been struggling to get axolotls.
Axolotls are, like, the best.
But then I realized, oh wait, I don't want my axolotls to kill my fish, so I'm gonna make a different tank for the axolotls.
That's a safe decision.
Oh, wait. And then, wait.
I don't
know what fish. I have a puffer fish in here, too, because I just want one.
Oh my god,
that's
the two.
Budget cheesy. No, yeah, because one of the birds reminded me of her, so I'm like, oh yeah, that's budget cheesy.
Oh, 100%.
Wait, 1 second. Here we go.
I love them.
Yeah.
The music disc.
Oh wait, I haven't shown you my farm. Or let me just...
I mean, if it helps, the stream is still down. Oh my god, the birds fucking dance!
Yeah, they dance. That's why I made a jukebox, okay?
I love everything about that.
I live in a treehouse. And I went to the nether to get some soul sand, so I have an up elevator and a down elevator until I make a sticky piston and make just one elevator.
I fucking love treehouses.
Do I know how to redstone? Hell no, so that's why I'll be looking at a tutorial online.
Fuck no, dude. I've been playing Minecraft for years and I still don't know how to fucking do redstone.
I did, however, look up a tutorial today and do something fun. Where is it? Farm! Well, I'm gonna wait for this dream catch up or whenever you say it. Fucking Christ, what's killing me? No.
Oh my god, she's already dying.
Look, I can't see half my screen. The phone's in the way. There's a zombie in my... Anyway... my farm.
Hello, farm.
No, one of my beets. One of my beets came undone because a zombie stepped on it.
Oh, how dare.
Fuck, I was gonna show you the button. Because I'm very proud.
Fucking diamond axe. Hello, zombie.
I fell on one of the beets.
Oh, my poor girl.
Look, I am getting better at this game. You have to trust me.
Well, you managed to successfully kill a zombie, so I think I can believe you.
It's daytime. It's also burning.
Look, okay, you're not helping your case.
Well, I'm gonna be honest. I'll be slightly honest.
I'm gonna be honest. Slightly honest.
Just give me this beet. Give me some bone meal. Christ.
Oh my god. I enjoy watching you suffer in video games.
I did fine with Genshin.
D-Luke.
My D-Luke is good. I'm not gonna go to Genshin just to show you my D-Luke's good. I am very proud of all my llamas, though.
Yes, be proud of your llamas.
Shizu mentioned I kidnapped llamas. I had to show you. Anyway, I should move my phone. There we go. I can now see my axe. Oh, right, I'm stuck in the glass.
She can see what's going on, lads!
Yeah, I have two axolotls. I just need to make a tank for them. Oh, wait. I didn't show you. Other than the giant fish tank. Enchantment table!
Fuck yeah!
I did get the jukebox first, though.
But it's clearly more important. How are you going to make enchantments without sick tunes?
My parents need to live in luxury.
Exactly.
And then I need to go iron farming for an anvil so I can put... I have 3 name tags, so...
You gotta name your parrots.
Yep. I have 3 parrots I'm gonna name. This one, Budget Shizu. My 2 other parrots, Budget Gin and Budget Yazoo.
Oh, oh my god, I have a budget pigeon? Fucking parrot? Yoru, do you fucking know what a bird is?
Well, I can show you the birds. They're at my other house.
Apparently I'm a dipshit and don't know what a bird is.
I may as well just jump off the balcony.
And like, you've got the best music box as well, like, the music CD as well.
Wait.
Rap, Cat is just the best fucking song, and yeah. I will not take criticism.
Or do I have bones? I can just bone meal this. I have bones upstairs, damn it. I just came down! Fuck!
Oh, you poor soul.
Yeah, because I would like to show you my farm, how it works, so I can eat. Because I don't have any other food on me at the moment. Because I live in the middle of the jungle. There's barely any pigs.
That is fucking relatable, my guy.
I chose an area that barely had any, like, actual animals.
You fucking dumbass.
Well, my second house has... I've killed some chickens. Wait.
My god. Chickens.
Oh, 2 golden apples.
Look at all those chickens.
Where the hell is it? Did I pass it? I don't know. Wait,
what are you looking for?
My bones. There they are. I'm dumb.
Usually they're in your body.
It's not that.
I don't understand why the fuck you don't worry me.
I will say, the height of my stairs is... a height that I can take damage at. I can't take damage anymore. Well, do I take damage now? Let me check.
Let me just yeet my fucking self.
No, yeah, I think it's the armor, since I fucking... I enchanted the chestplate and boots.
And what do we say when we get an impulse is to throw ourselves off a bridge? Yeet.
Oh, I made a little bridge. There are times my llamas belt at the same time, and I get so happy. Yes, I'm calling them my llamas. They are officially my llamas.
Now, apparently, there's 2 people watching.
Oh. Are there?
Mm. One of them is me. The other one is not saying anything.
Can you please? There we go.
Why did I just do it?
It only says one person is watching for me.
Mm, I see 2 people watching now. Plus the other one's you. But it said 1 last time.
Yeah, it said 1 when I was watching it. Okay.
That's trippy.
Ugh. I don't know what kills my plants.
Me. I kill your plants.
Okay. Is it all good now? Maybe? I think it's all good. I want to show you. I am so proud of it. Look, let me be proud about something in my life. can I hit the button from here? I can hit the button from here.
I think I have to watch the screen closely for it to actually happen on my end.
Okay.
These fucking dogs.
It missed one of my beats.
Oh no! Not the beat.
Other than that, I only missed one.
Oh shit, that's cool. Oh, I did miss one of the beats. Rip.
Yeah, and I have a replan by hand, but still.
Yeah, that's like fucking, oh, fuck that.
Yeah, but I'm still very proud. It's all redstone based.
Yeah. It's cool.
Because I'm too lazy to walk on my crops. Except to plant them.
Why are these fucking dogs barking? There's nothing there.
Maybe I should put two hoppers, because this is very slow.
I mean, that could work.
It is 64 of each. My god.
Oof.
Well, I can take what's there already, so I can start replanting right now. As soon as I put away my other items, because my inventory is almost full.
Rip.
I know we're supposed to be explaining ATD, but I'm literally just waiting for Shizu.
Yeah, Shizu's not here, so.
Well, you can start whenever then.
Every time they bark, I think that, like, Gigi's here, but she's not.
Oh, it does say two are watching. I just have to reload my shit. Do you think she... Well, do I ever check if she's messages me back?
Well, I mean, usually she'd be talking by now.
No, but the other thing, it's like 12:30 where she is, so like... She could be watching but not be saying anything.
I wish it, like, told you who's watching.
Yeah, but that feels a bit creepy also. Will I plant at night? Yes, yes I will.
She gonna die.
I'm not gonna die.
He's gonna die.
I'm not gonna die.
He's gonna die.
Alright, fuck you.
You're so nice to me.
I'm nicer than y'all do. Speaking of which, after I plant these, I'm gonna show you budget Yazoo. As soon as I sleep, because I'm not gonna travel in the night.
Yeah, because you're gonna die.
The difference is my treehouse is on a tree. I can sleep easier, while my shipwreck house is on the fucking beach. So there's literally mobs near it. I have to kill all the mobs first before I can sleep.
Relatable.
Oh, I also got four poisonous potatoes.
Oh, what a queen.
I got them from a shipwreck.
We love the venomous bitch. You fucking click undo, you absolute whore. It says. This is not going well for me right now.
Sometimes I wish in Minecraft there was an easier way to plant.
There probably is, he's just not thinking of it.
Fuck.
See, I robbed most things.
Did I ever... Wait. There's now a water bucket in my dispenser. That explains it.
Gasp, does it? I don't know.
All my dispensers have water buckets, so that's why the last beat didn't go down.
Oh no!
All the water flowed to the side, so that's why I touched everything else but that one beat, because there wasn't enough water.
That fucking beat, man.
I don't have enough iron to make a bucket, but I do need the iron to make an anvil later, so... Don't use too much of it.
Which one is more important, the anvil or that one beat?
I already made the bucket, so shut up.
Clearly the beat.
I have to help. Okay.
Understand, this is like my life.
Again.
Yeah.
Ah! What's killing me?
I don't know. What's killing you? The stream hasn't come.
No! My beat!
I'm, like, just on you making the bucket right now.
Okay, all the zombies are coming up. Jesus Christ. I'm not fighting four zombies.
Run away, Akari, run away!
This is why you live in tree houses! Look, I forget to eat sometimes, so I just don't. Is the one armor not burn?
No. No, it doesn't.
I did not know that! I may die!
No, you do?
I literally may die. Wait, what? Wait.
That was quick.
Maybe I should just let them all.
Right. He is gonna die from zombies first.
No, I'm not! I'll drown before I die.
You'll get killed by a drown?
No, I mean, I may drown. They fell in the water.
You're a dumbass.
No, 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 please don't! He hate you! Oh! I didn't have my shield.
I love how, you know, like,
maybe I should get my bow. Let me get my bow.
I love how zombies spin him.
Where the fuck did I put my bow?
Live. She lives. She's not gonna drown. But there's a creeper. She's not gonna drown.
That's why I yelled. I need some food. God damn it. Some beets. Come here.
You can't win.
You have to admit, I'm still doing better.
Yeah, you didn't die within the first 5 minutes.
We've not been streaming for 5 minutes. We've been streaming for 26.
Oh, fuck. Oh, wait. Oh, my God.
Doesn't Dante want to hear you watch the ATD stream?
I mean, probably.
No, you're the one who said he wanted to.
Well, yeah, he did, but, like, I'm not explaining it yet. Because we don't know if she's here.
Well, eh. Okay, how about this? Let me get my balls.
I thought you said your balls for a second there. Like she's getting her nutsack.
No. What the hell was that? I thought I heard a zombie noise. Mm-hmm. I forgot how to plug in the disc for a second.
You're dumbass.
No, I'm not.
You sure?
Yes.
Maybe she's just busy.
Oh, then you better start explaining then.
You got some explaining to do.
Woo! Yeah. I've never heard this full music.
Let me message. Okay.
I promise not to insult him too much.
I don't believe you, first of all.
Oh, no, you're justified not to believe me.
Rook is... Yep, I need to get a new fucking... Yep.
This music's so pretty! I've never heard
what's pretty?
I'm playing the parrot's music.
Oh.
I haven't heard the full thing of it. It's so nice. What? I got that disc like today.
You are so mega gay.
Of course I am.
Of course you are. You're my daughter.
No one's gonna understand that.
No, they're not. No. I feel like every time I say that in the chat room, people think that we're actually related and I'm just letting my daughter onto this fucking app.
Oh, no, yeah, I keep letting them think that.
And I'm like, Why does nobody think for, like, literally longer than 4 seconds, how would a 22-year-old have a 15-year-old daughter? No, nobody thinks. Big brain energy is not having been had.
This is now my new favorite music. This is so nice. Well, I gotta stop now. I gotta put in my bowls.
Gotta put her testicles away.
They're not testicles!
But they're your balls.
There you go. Oh yeah, we gotta go visit Budget Yazoo again. I don't know what to name the other parrot yet.
Ow!
Maybe I should make a new helmet and boots soon, but I really need that iron for the anvil.
You're in the fucking anvil.
I must name my parrots.
It's super important. Why don't you just find a village and use their anvil?
I live in a because I haven't learned how to do coordinates yet.
She didn't think about doing that.
No, if I travel like 1,000 blocks, I'm gonna get lost.
That's when you just die.
No! Because then I'm gonna lose all my stuff that I worked hard on.
Just bring nothing with you.
That's just a lot of dying then.
Well, yeah, but it's fine. Now only one person's watching. So it's me again. So it's not Shizu.
I can report my own video.
I love that. Why would you do that?
I'm sexually harassing myself.
I'm sexually harassing you. Help! Somebody in my stream is harassing me. Who is it? The guy that I'm fucking streaming with who keeps bullying my Minecraft skills.
I need to get to the shipwreck house. I forgot. I made the render distance shorter, so I just have to... There it is, okay. I will fix my render distance after this stream.
A safe decision.
Oh, would you like to also see my chickens?
I would love to see your chickens.
Tis I have kidnapped chickens. Oh, I accidentally hit a chicken.
Oh no.
Oh no, I killed a chicken!
Oh no. They're all gonna come for you now.
Well, at least I have food. What?
Yes, but damn.
I could literally say the same about you. You die. Oh no! At least I have food! One of my goddamn chickens got out.
Oh no, Ken's dead! Well, at least we have a snack.
So we lost two chickens.
We can just eat his corpse. That's what I would have wanted.
We lost two chickens because, well, one I accidentally killed, one I purposely killed got out.
Rip Jeremiah.
I didn't name the chickens!
Why not? I think Jeremiah is a swell name.
Because, like, there's over 20!
Yes. One of them needs to be named Hennifer.
Naming my goddamn chickens!
I will only name Jeremiah and Hennifer.
Are they the two that died?
Yes. Hennifer was wrapped in our house.
Oh my goodness. Why did you name one Jeremiah?
I don't know.
I just collected the eggs. There's so many now.
Well, I mean, now there's less because Hennifer and Jeremiah are dead, so...
It was an accident! One of them was an accident.
Jeremiah was the accident. Hennifer deserved it.
Look at all my chickens.
Hennifer's a bitch.
There are a few baby chickens in there, though. Breed chickens.
One of the baby chickens is Bridget.
We shall breed the chickens.
Breed them!
I want to make a really bad joke, but I'm not going to.
breed him.
That's not the joke, but okay.
It's because I'm so involved on TikTok right now. What do you think, Wackers Bonkers? Breed him. I'm a disappointment.
I didn't have enough fence, so I just put a door.
That's my girl.
And then the chicken got out.
I love how much it doesn't fit.
One of the baby chickens got out, but I don't want to kill a baby. So let me go get some seeds.
Kill Bridget.
They're gonna kill her.
Kill Bridget the baby.
I'm just gonna get some seeds. Before it turns night, I guess.
You just gave them seeds. Ah! Cat! Why? Oh my god, you almost fucking died just now. Are you okay, Leia?
What happened?
There she goes. She's not sitting there anymore. She just scared herself.
Well, I also bred some turtles.
Ah, I love turtles.
Come on. Come on. You get it back in the pen.
Yeah, Bridget, you fucking bitch. Stop taking off the henna for the ratchet ass bitch.
There we go. Got it. No, I'm gonna go sleep before any mobs come.
I should probably start explaining what the fuck I'm, like, doing here.
Yeah, that was the point. It said three people are watching now.
Okay. Okay, one of them's done.
Oh, wait. Budget Ganon, Budget Yasu!
What up, Budget Ganon, Budget Yasu?
You'll see on your screen.
Yeah, I gotta wait for the fucking stream to catch up. Wait, then who's the third person?
You looking at my birds?
I'm looking at your door currently.
Oh, oops.
Oh, there's the birds! Hello, birds.
Let's be a bud again. Bud Yazoo.
Yeah.
The gray one's Yazoo. And the rainbow one is you.
I am so gay. I even transcend Minecraft levels of gay.
That is literally all I came here for. This was a shipwreck, but then I diddied it up by carving out another shipwreck. There's a shipwreck on the water. So I'm making a bridge to this house, and I just stole some of the wood from that shipwreck. If Sophia decides to play, that'll be her house.
Yeah, because...
Did I ever learn how to grow sugar cane? I don't think I did. Oh, and the turtles. Turtle eggs. It's lots of turtles.
Twiddle!
I really need to make a fence for those chickens. Give me a second. Yeah. I'm gonna chop some wood.
Okay, yes, ATD.
Yep, sorry.
ADHD is like... Fuck, how do I start this shit?
I say how you created it. Okay. Is that another chicken I must lure?
Of course.
I heard a chicken. Maybe I can kill it. Chicken.
Fuck.
Chicken!
Originally, this was not supposed to be a thing.
Well, that's how everything starts out.
Well, some people plan things occurring.
That's a lie.
I'm not one of those bitches. No, like, originally this was not supposed to be a thing.
Yeah.
And originally, Gin didn't exist.
Well, yeah. He didn't come out of the womb yet.
The whole entirety of ATD was centered around Mitty.
Really?
Yep. All of it.
Do I have any dimples?
She was the main bitch. Which sounds super weird now that I think about it, because, like, she's plays like, such a small role now. Ripped. But originally
is this while
it was
you were...
all about her.
Yeah. Was this while you and Mitty were dating?
Before that. This shit's been going on for a long time. I think it's been like 6 years now. So there's a lot of story to cover. It all depends on like which version of ATD you go with, because there's four currently.
Yeah.
There's a lot. And like, whichever one you go with determines the rest of the story and who's involved. Like, originally, the original ATD storyline was Godkin.
Yeah.
Which is a whole fucking hot mess of, like, a good 3 years of work. Just in that one fucking timeline. And then you have Human Gin, which gives you a completely different cast of characters and a completely different storyline. And then you have Human Gin, but the alternate timeline, where Sam doesn't exist.
I have 16 eggs.
Oh my god. And then you have the current, like, fourth iteration of, like, Godkin in the current manga. There's a lot.
Yes. I am still listening, don't worry.
I'm like thinking about where to start. Where's the easiest place to fucking start? there's a lot there.
It's called There Is No Easy Way. Oh, I will say this. Oh. Oh! Dante is watching. Okay. No, I was gonna say, Dante, you can talk if you wanna. I promise not to mostly bully you.
She gotta be trusted, don't believe her.
Do you want me to bully you instead?
It's easy to bully me, Akari, and I'll bully you.
Yeah, I can bully you like... because you plagiarize.
Oh, yeah, sir.
Y'all just, we'll just plagiarism incarnated.
We'll get to the author. Okay, hang on. What's the short? The shortest timeline is probably.
Did you make notes for this like you said you were going to?
Of course I didn't. Why would I do that?
I thought we were going to explain the timeline in order. Because at least.
I mean, I'm going to, but.
At least now I know what my timeline's order is.
There's four different timelines all happening at the same time, so there really is an order on that.
Fine.
I guess, like, the shortest thing, because it hasn't been developed much, is, like, Gin with, like, Andy and shit.
Well, yeah.
There's not much there. That's been going on for, like, a year.
So yeah, I get it. There isn't a lot. God damn it, I have a chest.
A lot of that is just general, like, Human Gin storyline, which is longer, but with the addition of Andy instead of Sam. Because Sam, in this timeline, Sam and Gin never met.
Yeah.
But he did meet Andy and, like, Andy's siblings and shit. So,
anyway,
it doesn't really change much, honestly. There's not much there. Okay. But, like... Human gin is a fucking experience. There are two separate types of human gin. There is what I call pre-institution and post-institution.
Mm-hmm.
Which is mainly, it tells you what fucking length this hair is, mainly.
Oh my god.
It's okay, it makes sense, I swear. So pre-institution gin is, like, really good at emotions, like, super empathetic and shit, like, before he fucks off to set instant. Oh, look, I have cheese and bacon rolls.
I may have made too many fences.
Just a couple.
Yeah, I have like, five fences I don't know what to do with.
Pre-institution Gin is, like, super, super empathetic. He has a lot of, like, feelings. And generally, he was living with his mother, Shiori, and, you know, Yoshiko, Shinobu, and Ryota.
Damn it.
Which is super fun.
Bridget got out with her brother.
Bridget. For fuck's sakes, Bridget.
Need another, more seeds.
And pre-institution Gin is also the one with the long hair.
Yeah.
That becomes somewhat important. He's got the long hair and he's got the green eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Important. This is actually shockingly
important. Oh, Dante's asking how to join the call.
Oh, we're on Instagram. You can't really join, dude.
And I will tell you, you're not joining. This is my stream. You're flying with Hoshikuse. You're going along with Hoshikuse Air-lies. It's only us. So even if you offered, I would say no. It's not you. But I just don't want you.
It's the Hoshikuse family. Anyways,
there you go.
So, I don't really have a set time on when this happens. But it happens when Gin's in high school.
Yeah.
Which is Ryota, his oldest, eldest brother, you know, the one that we don't like.
Yep.
Because we like Shinobu.
Yes. He's
a twat that we like. His eldest brother gets offered a substantial amount of money to participate in experimental drugs. Which, you know, is actually a pretty fucking common thing, apparently.
That's where that came from!
Yes.
No, I remember you mentioning something like that when you lied to me for 3 years.
It's almost like I was following the canon.
It's almost like I was a naive 13-year-old who believed everything a 20-something-year-old told me.
I really did, and I... Sorry. I'm not gonna stop believing you for that. But, anyway. He got offered, a substantial amount of money to participate in these experimental drugs. But, of course, he wanted the money, he didn't want to do the drugs.
Yeah.
You know, like, normal fucking human being. So, you're instead calling your family normal?
I said, you're calling him normal?
Yeah, he fucking sucks. But instead of him doing the drugs and, actually signing up, he sent Gin away instead.
Yeah.
So, Gin got sent off to, you know, the Institute. And he had to be submitted to these, experimental drugs. Which fucked with his brain pretty severely.
He
became very, very much so unable to comprehend a lot of emotions. Which is also when, you get the artwork of Gin that has the bruises and injection marks on the inside of his elbows. But apparently nobody knew it was a thing until I actually started drawing.
Oh, no, I didn't know it either.
Yeah, because I always drew him in long sleeves. So when I finally drew him in a fucking t-shirt, I remember you saying, Jesus, that got fucking dark really quickly.
I can't go 10 seconds without these damn chickens making more eggs. I need a hopper for this bullshit. I need a chicken farm. I shall make a chicken farm. Stick them in the little box. Will I have to look up a tutorial? Yes.
Gotta go.
I'm sorry, I know you're still explaining, but I will give my commentary.
Dude, they're with a lot here. This is just human again. So after the whole Institute thing is when he ends up meeting Sam. And by this time, he still has his long hair, but he's wearing his contacts.
Yeah.
And he's refusing, outright, downright refusing to have anything to do with his brother.
Mm-hmm.
At this point, Ryota's just kind of disappeared. We don't know where he went.
You couldn't think of anything to do with him?
Well, depending on the storyline, he comes back.
Oh.
And, usually he comes back as one of Gin's teachers.
Ah.
That storyline was fucking fun.
You're the one writing this.
Yeah, it was. It's, dude, honestly, I have a lot of fun with this story. But, yeah, so... He ends up meeting Sam, and the one thing that remains constant in every single iteration is he always thinks Sam's a girl. It always fucks him up, because Gin's, you know, super fucking gay. So every time Sam's trying to hit on him, he's like, no, I'm not interested. I don't like girls. And every time Sam is standing there like, you fucking numpty, I have a dick.
I'd like to mention, this is your inner yaoi author coming out.
Oh, yeah.
Because there's no, well, I guess sometimes, in some implications, you get confused on gender. But, like, it really depends.
It's mainly because when Sam was created, like, when Mitty created Sam, she had no idea what she was going to make the gender of that character.
Ah.
So, it was just, they were supposed to look as androgynous as possible. And they did, and then eventually, Sam turned out to be a guy, and he's a whore. Yeah, that is fucking canon. He is canonically a fucking whore.
Yeah, I thought so. Gin really has a thing for brunettes.
Gin really has a thing for man whore.
No, what you mentioned the other day, like, wow, there's a lot of brunettes that he's dated, or I've dated since you were going to Skin, but I was like,
Yeah, wait. Yeah, he's apparently got a type, which is funny because he originally started off dating a girl with white hair.
Is that why Andy and you are shipped? No, I'm not gonna make that joke.
Exactly, he's got that type as, he's got that type as well.
I left my fences. No, I'm a dumbass.
At this point in time, Shiori has also disappeared. She's been put into a mental institution. Because she's fucking mental.
That's where that came. Every time you mention something I've heard, I'm like, that's where that law came from. Okay.
Yeah, it's okay. Everything is connected.
Yeah.
But, So, she was put into a mental institution, and Sam and Gin start getting close and dating and shit. And nothing really significant timeline-wise happens with them in that, circumstance. But, well, nothing until Sam ends up going over one night and staying the night. And when he gets up, he hears, like, just a really weird noise coming from the kitchen. He's like, what the fuck is that? So he goes downstairs, Gin's still asleep. He goes downstairs, and there's just a fucking woman standing in the kitchen cutting a radish. I don't know why it's always been a radish, but it's a radish. She's always cutting a radish.
Oh my god.
Yeah, but it's like this really weird, like, clopping noise when she's cutting it. So that's all he's hearing.
Oh.
And he's wondering fuck this chick is. Like, she's got red hair, so, and he hasn't met Yoshiko at this point in time, so he assumes that it's Yoshiko. It is not Yoshiko.
I'm assuming it's his mother.
It is Shiori, yeah.
Yeah.
Super. And this whole thing, this whole situation also happens in the timeline with Andy. So I count it as just, like, canon to that lore. It just depends on which person he's dating that it happens to.
Mm-hmm.
But Shiori's, like, really normal-looking. Like, she doesn't look insane, she doesn't really act insane, but her voice is really unsettling. And she's, like, asking him, like, hey, sit down, like, dinner will be ready soon. And, like, it's the middle of the day, and he's like, that doesn't sound right. Why are we having dinner? Who the fuck are you? But he was
reasonable reaction.
Huh?
Reasonable reaction.
Yeah, he's like, okay. And so he's like, okay. He was raised nice and politely, so he sits down and he's like, okay, I'm ready for dinner. Do you want me to get Gin? And he's like, yeah, go get Gin. So he goes upstairs, wakes Gin up, and he's like, somebody's in your house. And he's like, who the fuck's in my house? Why the fuck did you let somebody into my house? What the fuck, Sam? And he's like, no, it's a girl, she's got red hair, like, and again, Gin also thinks, oh, it's my sister, it can't be my crazy mother that is in a fucking mental institution, why would it be her?
Yeah.
It's her, buddy. Drop the fuck in.
It feels weird, because, like, I mostly call you Gin, even though I know your actual name is Alexander, and we're not saying your last name, because this is on the internet. But, like, sometimes when you talk about, like, Gin the character, I'm like, or just, I should just call it Gin, since that technically isn't you. I zone out for a bit, then I'm like, yeah, I keep forgetting that it's not a real person.
Me.
I have trust issues. And I can't tell what reality is. Sue me.
Don't worry. If it helps, not a lot of this has actually happened to me.
Fair enough. I just don't want you to be tortured.
No, I have not been tortured. Well, not much, not physically.
Gin, you gotta shut up for a bit. Yeah, I know. I was just going to the extreme.
You're being quite loud.
Okay.
You in particular.
Leave. You came in.
Man, I should have just come in from the start. We would have been doing this a lot easier. Instead of me hiding in your attic.
That's on stream now. It's on there forever.
Yep. Classic.
I have an officially anyway, two pickaxe now.
They both go downstairs. And Gin just kind of freezes. He's like, that's not my fucking sister. You need to fucking leave, Sam. Like, get the fuck out of here. This is not Poggers. But, you know, every time Gin's telling Sam, like, look, you need to go, you need to leave, like, immediately she will fuck you up, you need to go. Every single time he says that, Sam's, like, questioning him. It's like, why do I need to leave? What are you talking about, boy? Why do I need to go? Fuck off. But, so, he ends up stalling too long and saying, like, why do I need to go? For way too long, to the point where the meal gets finished. And now they have to sit down and eat, because Shiori's gonna get pissed if they don't. And you don't want Shiori pissed. She's insane. So they sit down, and she's got, like, a soup. And
yeah.
This has become just such a classic meme in this, like, ATD community, that you don't fucking trust Shiori's soup. This has happened that many times that we have learned not to trust her soup. Mainly because it's laced. Don't eat the soup.
Yeah.
And, you know, of course, they don't know this, so they eat the fucking soup. And, well, Sam eats the soup. He's polite. Gin doesn't touch the fucking soup. He knows. But he ends up eating the soup, and he ends up passing out because she already laced the fucking soup. You can't trust a solid half of this fucking family.
Sounds about right.
Half of them are fine. The other half fucking suck. Anyway, like, not a lot happens after that, but... if I remember correctly, fucking Yasu shows up.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Okay, now you gotta explain the plagiarism.
Ah, the plagiarism. Okay, so... If you know what Yasu looks like, he's a funky little emo. But
that's how you start it.
Yeah, am I wrong?
You're not, but
exactly. But if you don't know what Yasu looks like, Google Yabase from Hitorijime My Hero, because that's where he got his entire appearance from.
Of course, he's different now.
He's different now.
Wait, think about this. You plagiarized a character and I plagiarized a character. They both got different designs years later.
Exactly.
It's fate.
You know, he hates it. But Yasu ends up showing up because, okay, what's a good way to describe this? Yasu's fucking creepy.
What's a good way to describe? He's a fucking creep.
He's a fucking weirdo. But, okay. I say he's a creep, but, well, he is. There's no real but there, he fucking said. Okay, Yasu, canonically, is an informant. So he knows everything. So he has to know everything. And the way he knows everything is because he builds his own robotics.
I didn't.
So he's got several little robots.
Plot twist.
You didn't know that?
No!
Oh, okay, this will be great for you then.
Oh my god.
We'll go into, like, further detail about, like, Yasu's backstory in the Godgin timeline. This is just human gin. I told you, there's a lot here.
Yeah.
But, okay, he builds his own robotics. Specifically, he has robotic rats.
That's where that came from.
He has specifically one robotic rat, and then he has two just regular pet rats.
That's where that came from. I get it.
His robotic rat is Macbeth. Yeah, he named his rat Macbeth. The other two are Cravat and Skiomi. They're not entirely important. They still do the same kind of work. Like, he'll give, like, Cravat something, and then Cravat will take it to somebody else. But Macbeth has, like, recorders and shit, and, like, he can record audio, he can record visuals. His eyes are cameras, and they're also, like, projectors. And it's not just rats that he makes. He's also made dogs and fucking monkeys and shit.
I would like to mention, you mentioned that Yasu appears out of nowhere. For some reason, it's reminding me of the image where he's crawling through a window.
Ah, the window.
I like that image so much. I'm never gonna know what animatic that was for, but I love it.
It was for Meant to Be Yours from Heathers.
Ah.
Yeah.
Such gracious taste.
You're welcome. But yeah, so... Bro, originally also was so fucking creepy.
That explains everything!
And usually, he knows everything that's going on.
Yeah.
Because of, said rats. He's either got, his rats on the case, if he's specifically supposed to be following somebody in particular, but in his friends' houses, i.e. Aiko's and Gin's, he has cameras and bugs. Just to make sure, especially Gin's, in case, Ryota or Shiori comes back. That way he can show up and, you know, kick him in the face, I guess. With his stupid knife shoes.
That's where those come from. Okay. I'm getting the full backstory.
Fucking knife shoes. Yeah, it's almost like all of my artwork makes sense.
Well, that's most of it. Oh, that's why that exists.
Oh, yeah?
That's most of what it is. Oh, that's why that exists. I almost just died from fall damage. Ugh, zombies, again, stab, one has gold boots.
Anyway, so Yasu shows up because, you know, from these cameras and shit, he knows that Shiori is there. He doesn't know how she got there, or why she got there. So, you know, he's like, okay, Macbeth, you fucking, go and do your shit and find out why the fuck this happened. But he shows up, you know, to, you know, fucking rescue his stupid fucking redhead fire hydrant friend. But, you know, he also doesn't hit women. That's a lie. He does. He's an asshole.
I was gonna say, women. That's a lie.
Bitches if they deserve it. But not usually. Usually his morals say, I'm not going to hit a 40-year-old woman. But I'll... Yeah. Pull cue you.
That explains how it works.
Yeah, but... He shows up and he tells Gin, take Sam outside. I'll deal with this, you take Sam outside, because this motherfucker is unconscious anyway, so you may as well. So, Gin does that, Gin takes him outside, and we don't know exactly what happened inside that house.
Well, except you.
But when Gin goes back inside, Shiori's still awake and fine, and she's doing the dishes, and Yasu is, against the wall, because he's been fucking stabbed.
Oh, that explains that!
He got stabbed, like, I think 3 times.
I get to now understand everything else he's told me as well. Great.
Yeah.
I get to experience his stabbing for him.
So Gin ends up calling Mitty and says, like, look, take Sam, take Yasu, take, you know, Yasu to the fucking hospital and, you know, just take Sam and, I don't know, throw him in a dumpster somewhere, do something with him.
You're explaining it just as chaotic as the story. I love it.
You have no idea, bitch. This is just human Gin.
I'm very excited. You're now making me, like, set up my, like, you're now making me realize, oh, shit. You're amazing me already with one timeline. How is mine gonna go? If I don't impress you, I'm going to internally die.
It's okay. Like, this has been going for 6 years. There's a lot to cover.
Yeah, it's still scary.
So Mitty takes Yasu out to the hospital and calls Yasu's friend Sei. And we don't know what happens to Gin either until Sam, like, wakes up and comes back. Usually we just get, like, a whole fucking scene of Yasu in the hospital, Sei absolutely freaking out, like, bro, what the fuck, you could have died. And Yasu's, like, sitting there on the balcony, attached to IVs and shit, because, you know, he's been fucking stabbed. And this motherfucker's having a cigarette because he doesn't not give a shit.
I may die.
But it was super entertaining. Because he's like, bro, you could have died. Like, what the fuck were you thinking? And he's like, I'm having a cigarette. You think I could die from something that fucking stupid? Fuck you. So we followed that for a bit. And then when Sam got up and went back to the house, she already was gone again. Like, we don't know where she went again. She's fucking disappeared. Canonically, she fucks off to go live with Ryota and eventually, you know, comes back when she's needed for plot purposes.
Of course.
Which doesn't happen.
That's how characters work. I need you for plot.
Yeah, pretty much. It's like, I need you for plot reasons. Come here, you little redheaded fuck. But when Sam gets back, Gin's on the floor. He's pretty fine, but he's got hair all over him. Like, just everywhere. Because she already cut his hair with a knife. So this man's just, like, sitting there, like, yep. Having a small mental breakdown. Love you. And that's really all we have, like, canon-wise. Stories change from then on. It really depends on what we feel like doing at the time.
It really is that when it comes to, like, stories, you kind of just wing it the entire time. It's, I do what I feel like is mostly how I see it.
Like, because we've done so many different AUs in this universe using this cast of characters. Like, Gin's been a fucking, like, Gin's been mute before, he's been a vampire before. Like, you can do anything with these motherfuckers. And there's reasons why you can do anything with these motherfuckers.
Unless you have reasons.
The reason is the god timeline.
Yep. I'm just gonna fuck around and do what I want.
We have arrived at the god timeline. How do you feel?
That's a lot. that's a lot just for existing.
How do you feel? Well, I feel.
I thought you were talking to Torkoal, and I'm like, oh, he's actually asking me. Is that a fucking spider spawner? Yes, it is. God damn it.
It gets a lot, actually, like, way cooler from here. Because human timeline, there's only so much I can do with a human.
Yeah.
God timeline, I've got some cool fucking shit. And all of it's from my brain. Except for Yasu.
Actually, when did Yasu, or I mentioned this, like, already, but I was asking when did Yasu appear as an altar?
Around, like, 2018.
So, what year are we on the story?
I don't understand.
When you made this story, what year is it?
2016 was when we first started.
So when did you make the God timelines, basically?
2016 to 2017.
Yeah.
Oh, I love the God timeline so much. There's so much there, and it just gets better. See, I'm so proud of this whole experience because, like, everything makes sense. Everything is looped up, and
You're still watching stream, right?
Yeah.
So something good happened.
Oh, yeah?
You're watching it.
Yeah, but I'm delayed, remember?
Right. I got another name tag so I can name all my birds.
Fuck yeah.
And I got another disc.
Heck yeah.
I'll bet you $10 Sophia comes back in here saying, hey, can you shut up for like 5 seconds?
No, I cannot.
No, I meant me. I talk loud, remember?
Yeah, that's when you say no. Tell her to fuck off.
I'm not gonna tell her that. She's my sister.
She's me.
No, she's not.
So, originally, Gin also didn't exist in the God timeline, which was super quirky. It also wasn't a God timeline originally. It was just a normal, like, storyline. Because Mitty was our main character. And then I guess if you squint, you also had a pretty important role, but...
Ron. Nope. Not finding a skeleton. Nope.
You and skeletons.
I can't fuck with skeletons, my guy.
I guess the most important thing to actually start with would be, like, Mithy and Yasu, hey? Nothing before that really actually mattered.
Okay, give me... I didn't bring any coal, damn it.
Rip.
Give me a few seconds. I'm gonna smelt this iron and go to the bathroom and, like... Not, like, 9-game, but, yeah. Yeah, so, just entertain my chat. Or, don't I? Not with the God timeline. I would still want to hear that. Just say bullshit.
What the heck am I supposed to say?
I don't know. Do your best.
Naname, nanaju, nanadu, nanabi, nanakunaku, nanaku, nanahan, nanadai, nanaku, nanabite, nanakunagami. Stream is so fucking delayed. Y'all are just stuck with me for a bit. What am I supposed to say? I now understand the whole joke about why I am Sophia, because we are the same fucking person. I don't think that's a good thing. Oof. Delayed stream. I can hear my own voice. She's gonna come back and have to edit, do anything with this video, and there's just gonna be me talking my fucking ass off because I don't know what to fucking do. Why am I an Archon, Dante? And what am I the Archon for? Hear life. I hear noises of life.
I'm back. You miss me.
Yeah. I was telling the chat all of my deep dark secrets.
Ooh.
Yeah, I'm a total liar. Sorry, I'm not telling them shit. I did a stupid Japanese tongue twister.
Really? That's all you could think of?
Literally!
I didn't bring any wood with me.
Oh no. You poor bitch.
I thought I brought wood with me. Did I put it in the chest? I may put it in the chest. I may be an idiot. Not. I But there's wood right. What the fuck? Did I use all of it up? That's. Second chance. Same disc. Damn it. Ooh, coal. I literally could have got coal from this. I hate everything. Yeah, where's my wood? Oh, I'm dumb. It's in my furnace.
Oh, you said it.
It's in my furnace.
You're a dumbass.
Yeah, I know.
Kick, kick, kick.
Anyway, God time went.
Yes. Okay. Sorry.
It's like I have an officially pickaxe now.
Our original starting cast was Mitty, Yasu, and Aito. Because Aito existed before Ben, apparently. As an ATD character, at least. They all existed at the same time because, like, I created Gin first. And then Aito. And then Yasu. But I didn't know what I was gonna do with Gin, so I didn't do anything with him for at first. But, like, the whole thing started with Mitty and Aito being, like, high school friends. And Mitty had a boyfriend in high school. His name was Kisei, and he sucks. Not really. He's a total sweetheart. But one day, when everything is just normal, Mitty's going about her day, she goes down to the cafeteria for lunch. And there's just this shady-ass looking motherfucker in a rainbow fucking hoodie just standing by her table. And she's like, okay, are you looking for somebody? So she goes over and she's like asking him, like, do you need something? Like, is there somebody you're looking for? You look like you're looking for someone. And he just fucking stares at her. And he's just intimidating as fuck. Like, this man gives off a bad fucking vibe. But he stares at her, and he just walks away, and she's like, okay, the fuck? So she's just thinking, alright, I'll brush it off, it's fine. I don't know who this guy is, and maybe he had the wrong person. He did not have the wrong person. He's fucking looking for you. So she looks around to see where this guy goes, and he's standing by the door just looking at her. And he, like, beckons her over, and then walks away again. And she's standing there, and she's like, I don't know who the fuck this guy is, or what the fuck this guy wants. What the fuck? And as she's about to leave, one of her friends grabs her hand, and he's like, no, don't fucking follow that guy. And she says, why? And he says, no, like, trust me, don't fucking follow this guy. He has just the worst reputation. He will probably fucking sucker punch you in the gut. Because he fucking sucks. There's, like, rumors that he runs with a gang and shit.
And place your bets, people.
And Mitty stands there, she's like, awesome.
I think I know who this is.
Yeah, you probably do, love.
Place your bets.
Place your bets on who she could be following upstairs. But she does, and she follows him upstairs. And she's face to face with this stupid looking fucking emo kid.
Yep. Your bets are over. All your money's mine. You were fucking wrong.
No! Leia!
I don't know if I made you laugh or it was the cat, but either way, I'm proud of my own joke.
You dumb fucking bitch. I was laughing at you. The cat. No. You dumb fucking idiot. Oh my god, are you okay?
It was the cat.
She fell off the back of the table and she grabbed hold of the fucking pencil case as she was falling. She's just looking at me like, Dad, help. Okay. Right. That fucking got me. Back to ATD. That's now. I wish I could have gotten that on film. Oh my god. That was so funny. Right, yes. So she goes up to this guy, and she's like, okay, you wanted me? Like, what, do I know you? What do you want? And he looks at her, and he's like, fuck you. And she's like, what? Your first words to me are gonna be, fuck you. Who the fuck? Fuck you. And Mitzi is not as sweet as she looks. She really fucking isn't.
Yeah,
she, she's kind of a bitch.
Gravel, gravel, gravel!
Well, we're gravel. But she's not as nice.
I'm gonna die!
What a stupid way to die.
Shut up! I'm building up to get to my house!
So, she ends up talking to this guy, aka Yasu. And at this point, all she knows about this man is that his name is Yamase. And that's it. But he immediately, like, starts threatening her. And she's like, what the fuck is going on? But he's threatening her because he has, like, a crush on her boyfriend. Because, you know, Yasu started off as pretty fucking gay. That changed. That's also why he's labeled as bi, by the way.
Mm.
Yeah. Things come full circle.
Actually, was the actual Yasu bi?
Yeah. But, so he starts threatening her, like, basically, like, saying, hey, break up with your boyfriend. Fuck you, he doesn't even like you, like, he's just a general fucking asshat. Like, he sucks, he really does suck, and he just gets worse.
That's...
But, she basically says, go fuck yourself, and leaves. But, after that, she sees this man a lot. Like, he pops up all the fucking time. And he starts talking with her boyfriend a lot, and they end up becoming, like, okay friends, because her boyfriend is a sweetheart. About her fucking husband, isn't it? But they end up becoming a pretty decent friend, so Mitzi's seeing a lot of this guy. And while she's seeing a lot of this guy, she's hearing a lot more rumors about this guy. Mainly that he's in a gang, like a really fucking severe gang. He's, like, not second in command in said gang. He works with the Yakuza. He's killed people. Like, she's hearing all of this shit. And she's thinking that a lot of them are just rumors. And a lot of them are. But he does run with a gang. And he is second in command in said gang. He's not a nice man. But at this stage, he doesn't work with the Yakuza. And he hasn't killed anybody. Super. We have a redeeming quality for this man. Holy shit.
You're in a gang, but not the worst gang.
Hold on to that redeeming quality, because there won't be any more of them.
Oh, I understand why it took me so long to climb up, and there's a skeleton firing at me. Of course there is. Well, I guess I'll die.
Rip.
No, I'm on a mountain.
Double rip.
I was climbing... I was mining for iron, and I accidentally, when I was climbing upward, I went far, and I may die! I'm on half a heart.
Oh, that sucks.
And that's from fall damage! I'm, like, right in front of my house. If I die in front of my house, I died in front of my house.
Oh my god, Akari.
That was my first death. I'm at the shipwreck. I forgot to reset my spawn in the treehouse!
Oh no.
I have 5 minutes to get myself. Holy shit.
Oh, you poor bitch.
Shut up.
Anyways. So, the more she hangs out with this dude, the more she's like, look, you're not as bad as you think. And he gets offended. He's like, bitch, I'm way worse than you think. Fuck you. He doesn't like being seen as a good person.
Oof,
which, I mean, you know, whole last move there.
Yeah, at least you got that after it.
They hang out more. And at this point, she starts, like, realizing, like, oh, fuck, this guy and Aito are really good friends. Ew. Why is Aito friends with such a horrible human being? And, obviously, because Aito is friends with everyone. He's a fucking sunshine child.
Oh, did Aito come first? I mean, actual Aito. Did Aito come first or Yasu?
Yasu.
Really? Didn't expect that.
Yeah. Fuck you.
If all my stuff despawns, all those hard work I got for those diamonds, I'm gonna be so mad. Crack my wrist, damn it.
So not a lot of shit ends up happening for, like, a significant period of time, honestly. It's just them going about their average day. And then Mitsu goes over to Kisei's house. And, you know, they have, like, a nice, lovely boyfriend-girlfriend night of watching movies and shit. Until they're sitting in Kisei's room, and Mitsu gets a text on her phone. And this is another one of Yasu's stupid little quirks, is he knows everybody's phone numbers. Because, woman. So he will send you the weirdest texts. Like, when, say, first touched down in fucking Japan, he sent him a text, and they had never met before, but he sent him a text saying, welcome to Japan.
That's not quirky, and that's later, creepy.
That's fucking creepy as shit. Because he had come from Korea. But he's like, welcome to Japan. Because he knows that that fucking stupid little bastard is the fucking Korean Prime Minister's son. And he is there. So, he knows everybody's phone numbers, and beforehand, he obviously was not exchanging any messages with Mitsu because they fucking hate each other. Why the fuck would they? Why would they just be sitting there texting like a couple of schoolgirls? But he sends him a text message. He sends her a text message that just says, get him out, get him to leave. And she's like, what the fuck? And she's like, first of all, who the fuck is this? And he tells her who it is. And she's like, firstly, how the fuck did you get my phone number, sir? Secondarily, where the fuck are you? What do you mean make him leave? How do you know we're together? And he said, I'm in the closet. And she's like, you're in the fucking what? He's like, I'm in the cupboard. Like, I'm in the cupboard. Knock, knock. Like, and she's like, oh,
can you talk about how creepy ATD Yasu is?
Oh no, dude, fucking, I was about to call you Georgia. Like,
excuse me. How fucking dare you?
He's fucked up. And this isn't the creepiest shit that he's done. He's done worse things.
You never want to hear that, but okay, keep going.
So, she's like, alright, I am terrified of what this man is going to do to both me and my boyfriend if I don't do what he says. So she says, like, look, I'm feeling sick. Can you go down to the, like, convenience store and can you get me, like, some flu medication? And he says, like, a golden retriever boyfriend. So he's like, fuck yeah, I'll do that. I love you. So he leaves. And, like, 10 minutes later, Yasu just fucking creeps out from this wardrobe and Mitsu's shitting bricks. She's like, holy fuck, you were really in there. What the fuck? How long have you been in there? He's like, dude, I've been in here for, like, a couple hours. I do this a lot. That's where the classic joke of Yasu in the fucking cupboard comes from. Oh, I love that. But they end up talking, and it's not a nice talk, and they end up in a fight. They end up in an actual, like, fist fight. Like, Mitsu is not a strong woman, like, just in general. Not pre-Yasu, at least. She does not know how to defend herself. And this man is, like, just fucking... Anytime she comes close, he's, like, backhanding her and shit. I told you. He does hit women.
Yeah.
Usually they deserve it, but this time, Mitsu did not. Original series, Yasu just fucking sucked. He's not a good person. I don't know why people like him.
They but like
everybody
me.
Likes him now.
Why do you like child?
Shut up.
Right!
Right, for the same reason that everybody likes Yasu. He's fucking hot.
I'm not agreeing with that one.
Kisa ends up coming home and, like, breaking up the fight and shit, and we don't see anything to do with Yasu for a long period of time. And Miti honestly thought that he had just given up. Yasumi Yamase doesn't give up on shit. Literally ever. Man can be shot and still not give up. He's a fucking trooper. So she ends up trying to find him because she's like, something's wrong here. Something feels off. I don't like this. And she does end up finding him at his house, you know, where he lives. Because where else would he fucking be? But the thing about, like, original series Yasu is he didn't really have a house. He did have a house, but it wasn't really a house. It was a half-burned-down house. And he was just living in, like, this dilapidated house near the fucking... near the carnival. Where else was he gonna go? He does end up, like, finding somewhere to stay, but originally he was just, you know, vibing there. And she finds him, trigger warning, trying to fucking hang himself. She's like, no. Yeah, there's a... I should have, like, warned everybody at the start of this that there was going to be talk of suicide because Yasu exists.
No, it's fine.
But, yeah, it's okay. They're there. He doesn't end up succeeding.
I know.
But she ends up getting him down and she's like, what the fuck, bro? Like, literally, what the fuck? And this is where he confides in her, like, look, I can't fucking do this shit anymore. Because I am ending up, like, falling in love with somebody that I didn't want to fucking fall in love with. Because you fucking suck! He's genuinely mad that he was, like, developing feelings for her. And she's standing there like, bro, what the fuck? First of all, you don't just fucking run and die when that shit happens. Secondarily, what the fuck? And he's like, no, I don't want to do this. Fucking see you later, bye. And he tries, like, leaving, and she stops him, and she's like, no. First of all, we need to fucking talk about this, because, dude, Jesus fucking Christ, you can't just do that shit. And he's like, fucking watch me. But, yeah, this whole section in the story is really fucking trigger warning me, because he takes one of his knives and tries to slash his wrist in front of her. And she's like, oh, thanks, I fucking hate it here. But he passes out, and she calls an ambulance and takes him to the hospital. And while he's recovering in the hospital, he's, like, talking to her, saying, like, look, fuck you for saving me, first of all. And fuck you especially for making me develop feelings for you, you fucking whore. Because they're angry at each other, just all the fucking time. And she decides, yeah, okay, it's fine. You can sit here and recover, I'm gonna go. Bad idea. I promise, this is the last time. Maybe, unless I remember another part. But she tries to leave, and while she's leaving, she realizes that she left her phone in the hospital room. So when she goes back, she finds this motherfucker once again trying to fucking die, because he's trying to, like, take pills. Because it just seems like nobody's letting this man die. And it's me. I'm the one not letting this man die. Because I like him too much.
I wish you're self-aware.
She stops him again. And he has a full-on breakdown. It's like the first time you canonically see us, you have a breakdown. Doesn't happen often.
Yeah, I can see that.
But he ends up, like, if you remember the glorious... original design of Yasumi Yamase. He wears a key around his neck.
Yeah.
Ding dong. Yeah, that has plot relevance.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. What a twist.
But, you know, plot relevance, love that for us. But he ends up giving her that key. And this key is, like, super rusted. There's no way in hell that it can be used in anything. It'll, like, you put it in a lock and it'll break. Because he's had it around his neck for so long. But he gives her the necklace. And he's like, just, I don't know, take it. I don't fucking want it anymore. And she's like, what's it to? Like, can I use it in anything? Like, and he says, no, not that one. But you can use this one. And he gives her, like, a brand new key. And he's like, if you can find it, you can have it. And she sits there and she's like, okay, that's fucking cryptic, but, you know, when has this man not been fucking cryptic? I hate it. But, so, she takes the key and she goes back to his house. Because she's like, well, if he's gonna have anything, it's gotta be here. And it is. And it's this little, like, metal box. And she unlocks it, and it's full of just memories and shit. Like, it's full of, like, old photos and, like, just random shit, to be honest. I don't really remember what was in it, but I remember, like, there were some photos of his, like, parents and shit in it. And it was, like, his prized possession. It was the only thing that he owned that wasn't destroyed, really. But, like, she takes it back to him, and they have a long heart-to-heart talk, and, it's gross and feely and disgusting.
That's your reaction.
Yeah, there's emotions and shit, and we don't do that here, ew. But he confides in her all about, like, Sora Street and shit that I don't want to, like, go over because it's
we are not going to. I don't want to go over it either.
Yeah, no, it's fucking sad. Fuck you! But he confides in her all about Sora Street and shit like that. And they end up getting really close and shit. And nothing happens, again, for a significant period of time. They're, like, doing their normal day-to-day shit. I'm pretty sure Miti entered a polyamorous relationship between him and Kise. Which was super dope and unplanned. A lot of this was unplanned.
But my mouth started tastes like metal.
Nothing happened until the day of the summer festival.
Mm-hmm.
Which is where everything happened. Which is where we get our first instance of good old-fashioned gin. Because, yes, he exists. It's almost like he's a main character. But he wasn't until now. But this is where shit gets fucking magical, I guess. Until now, it wasn't intended on being. But they go to this festival, you know, as you do in Japan.
Yep.
And Mitzi's trying to pay attention to the fireworks, but she keeps seeing this stupid, like, stupid-looking guy in the crowd, and he's wearing a fox mask. And she thinks nothing of it because it's a Japanese festival. Everybody's got masks on. But nobody has this type of mask on. It's very specific. But she's looking at him, and she's like, something's wrong, who is this guy? Why does he keep staring at me? And why is he in every single crowd that I'm in? But she's like, okay, maybe it's just a coincidence. You know, I'm a dumb bitch. Why would it be anything but intentional? Because it's Gin. Gin's following you. But she doesn't think anything of it, and she just goes about her day.
Mm-hmm.
And Yasu ends up leaving early. And she's like, okay, cool, bye, see you later. No, wait, hang on, I'm remembering, sorry. He left early to go and get Kise's sister Rui, because she was taking too long. So he went to go and find her to bring her to the festival. That's where shit fucks itself up. Because Rui was taking so long because she was trying to die. Everybody in ATD is depressed, sorry. But, so, in doing so, he tries to find her, and he ends up saving her life. Because Yasu. Good feelings with Yasu, because he's not a total asshat. He's just a semi-asshat. So while he's trying to save Rui, he ends up himself falling off the balcony and into the water. So Yasu ends up going to hospital again, but yep. He doesn't survive this time. Yasu canonically fucking dies.
Huh.
Many times, actually. But during this entire time, like, while, like, all that shit's happening and he's saving Rui, Michi's walking after him because she has a bad idea. Like, she has a bad feeling about this. But she ends up getting to the, like, base of the building right as Yasu's falling off the building. And while, like, she doesn't know, but Gin's following her as well, because he knows what's gonna happen. It's fucking Gin. So, he goes to the hospital, and Yasuo ends up dying. And everybody's, like, there in the hospital, like, oh, fuck, that just happened, what the fuck? Minty's fucking distraught. And she leaves the hospital room, and Gin's just fucking standing there with his stupid fucking fox mask on. And she gets really mad at him. She's like, what the fuck do you want? Who the fuck are you? Like, what are you doing here? And he's like, hi, what's up? I'm Gin. That's my friend that just died. Rip. And he starts saying really cryptic things. He says shit like, it's okay, like, it was supposed to happen this way, like, but I'm not gonna let it happen this way. And she's like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, literally, bro, I just lost my boyfriend. Can you shut the fuck up, please? But he's like, it's okay. It won't stay this way. Or at least not forever. And she's confused, she doesn't know what's going on, but she leaves, and she doesn't see Gin again for a little while. But when she does, you know, that motherfucker's following her as usual, because he's creepy as shit. Runs in the ATD timeline that everybody's just fucking creepy.
Yeah.
Except for Aito. Aito's not creepy. Aito's a good boy. Which reminds me, because next up to die is Aito.
Oh, God. I honestly don't have much to say, I'm just listening. Until you ask me my opinion, so I'm like, oh.
It's okay, there's a reason that Aito dies. But, you know, there's not supposed to be a reason that Yasuo dies. Yasuo's not supposed to die, which is the whole point of why Gin is there.
Yeah.
But Aito ends up falling off the school rooftop. And everyone gets super fucking confused, because it's like, what the fuck? Like, why would he choose to die? Like, I don't understand. And as he's dying, the sun's going down. And everyone's like, what the fuck, what the fuck, what the fuck? And Gin's like, nah, I'm bored. Like, I'm done. All right, Mitty, come here, you fucking vegetable. We're fucking shit up. And again, she doesn't know anything about this dude. Like, literally nothing. All she knows is that Aito and Yasuo are friends with this stranger. And now they're both fucking dead. And now this stupid redhead is left. But he ends up, confronting her on the rooftop when she's, like, freaking out over Aito's death. And he asks her, if you had to live in a world with just useless people, would you live in it? And she's like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, what? Please, I've lost my boyfriend and my best friend. Can you please shut the fuck up if you're not gonna tell me something useful? But he just keeps asking her the same question. Would you choose to, live in a world where only useless people exist? And she just said, like, she ends up getting so frustrated, and she yells at him, like, look, if it would bring them back, I would. Even if I had to be the useless person. And Gin's like, alright, sick, come with me. And she's like, what the fuck? And she ends up blacking out. The reason for that is Gin wasn't touching her. But she ends up blacking out. But unlike everybody else that this has happened to, like, you know, Yasuo and Aito and shit, she remains with her memories of the past timeline. Because Gin fucks with timelines.
Yeah.
He ends up taking her to a secondary timeline where Yasuo doesn't die like that. Specifically like that. He does die, but not like that.
You
the
know,
same thing ends up happening.
Anyone who knows me knows I love good old-fashioned time loops.
There's a lot of them in this.
Mentally torture them.
But Mitty, of all people, keeps her memory. And again, there is a reason for that, but it doesn't come into play until a while later.
Of course.
Everything has a reason in this.
At least you know what you're doing.
Yeah, but I don't!
Why does it make sense? Yours does.
But, okay. So, She keeps her memories, and she's really confused because nobody else does. But it takes her back, I think. I believe it's, like, after the festival. But everyone's still alive. But, like, Rui's still suicidal, and she's going to attempt again. And Yasu is obviously still fated to try and help her. But when he does do that, and that does happen, Mitsuya already knows what's gonna happen. So she stops the whole event. Which, in turn, you know, fucks with the timeline. Which blights Gin. And blight, for those who don't know,
me,
is fucking hot. Okay. There's two different punishments for gods and death. Or gods and deaths. Deaths are like things like succubus, incubus, demons, Ayakashi, phantoms, and undead, like undead beings. Mm-hmm. And then there's obviously gods. Blight is what happens when a god breaks the rules. Mm. Which happens to Gin a fucking lot. Because, you know, he's always fucking with the timelines, especially if it's to save somebody's life, which he really shouldn't be doing, because he fucks himself up. And blight can appear in as both a bite or a sting. Bites are what happens when he's touched by phantoms, and stings is what happens when he breaks the rules. Both of them start at the back of the neck, and it's like this kind of hissing purple infection type thing. And it spreads down his body the longer it's left unchecked. And, you know, super fun. And then for deaths, their punishment is they get cut off from society, cut off from humanity. Humans can't physically see them or interact with them or, like, touch them or anything for, like, several days. It's a lot less dramatic. But Gin obviously gets fucking blighted. A lot. And it fucks him up. A lot. He sucks at this whole thing. I don't remember where the fuck I was up to. Fuck. Where was I up to?
Gin, something amazing has happened.
Oh yeah?
I made my anvil.
What a queen.
I know I'm interrupting you. I'm sorry, but like...
It's okay, I don't remember where I was up to, fuck.
I'm sorry!
I was talking about blight, and I don't remember why I was talking about blight.
You were talking... Timeline reset.
Yes.
Yes. You're like my mother. She'll be talking about something, and then be like, why am I talking about this?
I'm like every member of your family now.
No, not my dad.
But I am your dad. So, in doing so, of, like, Mitty preventing Yasu from dying in that whole situation with Rui, the timeline has to shift, and it has to kill Yasu in a different way. Which is a very dramatic way, mind you. But, you know, it's Yasu. He's gotta die somewhat dramatically, and you're probably gonna laugh at this.
Bring it on.
It's super stupid, but I couldn't think of anything else. But, Yasu and Aito end up dying pretty similar, like, in the same event. So, Yasu had a part-time job at a ramen place.
Yep.
Yeah, not something you'd expect from that man.
Fair enough.
But he gets into a fight with Mitty. I don't really remember what about, to be honest. It wasn't really that important. All that mattered was that he was mad at her. And she stopped by at his work to try and talk to him. And obviously, he didn't want to talk to her. So we sent her away. And as she was, like, when she was in the shop, she noticed that there was a really weird smell. But she didn't place it. She's like, alright, it's the smell of ramen. It's not the smell of ramen. Ramen doesn't smell like that. Ramen smells good. This smells bad. As she's walking away, get this, the fucking ramen place blows up. Because that fucking smell was the water heater malfunctioning. and it ends up blowing up, and it ends up fucking killing Yasu. Motherfucker dies in a literal explosion.
I mean...
Big rip.
That's a very Yasu death.
It really is.
I don't know what else to say other than that. That's a very Yasu death.
But Mitsu's freaking out. She's like, what the fuck, what the fuck, what the fuck? And Ito comes up. And he's like, fuck. This ain't great. This is not poggers. So he runs into the burning building to try and find Yasu. Yasu's already dead. Yasu literally died on impact. Like, he's fucking gone, bitch. It got exploded. He ain't living through that. But while, like, Mitsu calls a fire, like, fire brigade and shit, and when they arrive, they take, you know, two bodies the shop. And Ito had died from smoke inhalation, and Yasu had died from, you know, blowing the fuck up. I promise, this is, like, the second last time Yasu actually canonically dies. He does die one more time.
Okay.
Sorry. I'm just preparing you for that.
Okay, ready.
But once again, Gin's pissed. It's like, this is some fucking bullshit. But, you know, while, like, Mitty's watching all this shit, like, these bodies being taken away and freaking out, the sun sets again. And I promise, that's actually important. But, she's obviously not connecting these dots, but Gin is. Gin knows what's happening. Or at least Gin knows what's happening with Ito. But he's like, fuck this, I'm getting pissed off at this. Surely I've got to find at least one timeline where both of my fucking friends live. So he switches the timeline again. Because, you know, he's an asshole. And he likes getting his way. So once again, Mitsu has all these memories. And she ends up discouraging Yasu from even working at the joint in the first place. That doesn't work. He works there anyways. But she ends up distracting him all day so he doesn't go to work the day that the water heater blows. So he ends up living again. And everyone's like, sick, awesome. And at this point in time, Mitsu's starting to connect dots of the time loops being connected to the fact that Gin is always there. And she knows nothing about this man. She doesn't even know his last name. She literally doesn't know shit because Gin doesn't fucking have a last name. He does, but he doesn't. It's not a real last name. That also has the explanation on how that works and why Yoshiko is not a god. But she doesn't know shit. But she's connecting the fact that these two things have to be related. So she confronts him. And Gin has never been good at hiding his godlike status. He actually sucks at it. So when she asks him what's going on, he says, I'm the god of time. And she's like, very funny, you redheaded fuck. You are not. And he's like, I swear to fucking Buddha, I swear to me, that I am the god of time. And she's like, very funny, haha. And then she fucking leaves. And Gin's like, I fucking hate it here. I hate humans. Fuck you guys. Like, they never fucking believe him.
Well, if you're telling someone you're a god, of course they're not gonna believe you.
Exactly. There's also a fucking, a whole joke that, very much so later on in the series, in the fucking reincarnation loop where Gin meets Sam as a god, he goes to the fucking library and he's looking in a book of, like, mythological creatures and gods and shit in different religions, and he's sitting there getting mad because they never have him. So that's another random fucking, like, god-gin joke that we've got going on. But obviously she doesn't believe him, because why the fuck would you believe him? Like, he has given you nothing to work with. And he sucks. So, she's like, nah, fucking bye. I'm gonna go find my boyfriend. And she does. She goes and she finds her boyfriend. You know, that shitty Yasu guy. That everyone's super attached to. Yeah, that guy. Fuck that guy. But it's at this point that Gin thinks, you know, fuck this shit. I'm gonna prove to you that I am the fucking god of time. I don't know how I'm gonna do it, but I'm gonna do it. And you, fuck you for doubting me, you fucking bastard. But, so, nothing really happens, or at least Ken doesn't let anything happen, until before they graduate. At said graduation, shit goes down once again. Because it's Yasu. He doesn't have a lot of friends. No, because he fucking sucks.
I would like to mention, if the quality of Gin sounds really bad, it's because I'm holding my phone to Google something at the moment. So I just want to apologize if this sounds... I'm holding it up to the mic still, but... So, yeah.
Comedy.
This is important.
But at this graduation, everything's normal. Everyone's doing their, like, last hurrah shit. Yeah. And then somebody comes into the pool. And at this point, Mitty doesn't really know who this guy is, but Yasu does. Remember how I told you that Yasu was in a gang?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, this is the leader of that gang.
Of course. You
know, the number one. And, Yasu, you know, because he's got a girlfriend and a fucking life now, he hasn't been showing up to do said gang-related activity, which means this gang is down their lead informant. And that's not good. So instead of talking to him, you know, like a normal fucking person, he shoots him. In the face. Mitty was very pissed off about the actual Mitty. But, yeah, Yasu gets shot, like, in the forehead, and literally dies instantly. And Gin's like, I fucking hate it here. Why does this shit keep happening? What the fuck? So, he ends up going to Mitty, you know, while Mitty's like, bro, like, my fucking boyfriend, what the fuck? She's seen a lot in this past, like, fucking... In the past few weeks, man. She's been through a lot. She's gonna be through a lot more.
Gin?
Uh-huh?
Wendy, Mom? Gin, how many more timelines and explanations do you have?
Not too many.
Can we get through these? Oh, they'll turn Gin down. Well, too bad. He's the same person as me. I love you. Love you. Night. I'm in the middle of name tag renaming. Anyway, keep explaining.
So Gin ends up going to, you know, Mithy, and he's like, look, I can't fucking do this anymore. I hate it here. Like, please, stop fucking killing my best friend. I'm begging. And Mitty's like, bro, it's not my fucking fault. But he's like, look, I will give you one more chance. Literally one more chance. You gotta fucking work with me on this. But you need to believe the fact that I am a god. And she's like, dude, I'll believe anything at this point. I'm fucking done. My boyfriend has died like 4 times in front of me. I'm really fucking over living here. I'm thinking about moving to America. But, so, he resets the timeline again. Mm-hmm. But this time it's different. I don't really remember how it's different, but I know it's different.
But now... I have a question for you. Does Andy have an Instagram?
Huh?
Does Andy have an Instagram?
Yes, indeedy.
Have you shown him my Instagram?
No way.
Because someone named Andrew James, not gonna say the last name, just follow me.
Oh, no, that's Dante.
Oh, I forgot, they have the same name.
Correct, yes.
Anyway.
So, Mitty now is very aware that Gin is a god because, you know, he showed her his actual powers. Because this time, when he reset the timeline, he actually touched her. So she could see, while he was resetting everything, timelines flashing by her. She's like, well, this can't be fake. Either that or I'm, like, severely high. And we know that that's not happening. But, so she's actually believing this man. She has no reason to doubt him anymore, especially because every time she's asked him a question after this, he's literally just shown her. He's like, yep, cool, here you go. Like, this is what I have to do this and this and this. But now Gin's very fucking blighted because, you know, Gin, he can't stay out of trouble for more than 2 seconds. So Mitty asks him what's the deal with the blight. Because with this new timeline, Gin accidentally went too far. He skipped forward through all of high school, all of it. It's all gone. Now everybody's adults. And everyone's confused. But Mitzi's the only one that doesn't have memories of becoming an adult. So Mitty asks Gin, like, what's the deal with the blight? Why is your neck purple, sir? Did you get a tattoo? And he says, fuck no, why would I do that? And he's explaining to her, look, this is blight. She's like, thanks, that's unhelpful. And he explains to her, this is what happens if I break the rules. She's like, what do you mean by break the rules? And he said, well, I'm not really supposed to be saving Yasu's life here. You know, it's kind of not supposed to happen. But if I can get him past his fucking teenage years, this stupid idiot can actually survive. I've just been doing that in a really roundabout way, and now I gotta do it the actual way. So, and he tells her, look, blight is the only way that I could really, actually, if you squint, die. And she asks, like, oh, you can die. And he's like, yes and no. I can explode into a pile of ink, but that's really as close as I get to dying. And she's like, what the fuck does that mean? He's like, I'm not gonna show you. But he takes off his shirt, and he's got the Gin kanji on his chest. And she's like, what the fuck is that, first of all? Why does it say your name? Second of all, how did I never notice that before? And he says, like, look, this is my, human name, if you want to call it that. It's not really, but he doesn't have a human name, he's not a human, but this is what people call me. And she's like, okay, sick, obviously, it's your name. And he says, that's the thing, it's not my name. She gets super confused. And she says, what do you mean, what's your name? And he says, I can't tell you that. Because if I tell you my posthumous name, you will be able to control me. And she's like, I can do what? And that's the thing with these gods. Shinobu included, and Yasu included, they all have a posthumous name. Which is, you know, their god name. And if a human were to call that name, they would get to make a wish on that god. On that god and their energy. Which is horrific if you, you know, are friends with fucking Yasu, who's the god of calamity. You don't really want that motherfucker to be able to be granting wishes. But, so she asks him what his name is, and he says he's obviously not going to tell her. But he does have the kanji for Yoru on the back of his hip. And that kanji can be written, read three different ways. So you can have Ya, Yo, and Yoru. Which is why I found it so funny with the fact that both of our names have that kanji in it. Except yours is written as Ya, mine's written as Yoru. Super entertaining.
Oh, wait, you mentioned... Sorry, I blacked out during that part. When you were talking about our names, because Japanese.
Yes.
I'm sorry. I'm not stupid!
But she ends up, like, seeing this kanji, and she's trying to figure out his name. I don't know why she was trying to figure out his name, but I guess she just wanted to know. But she ends up saying, like, Yagin, Ginya, Ginyo, Gin, like, Yogin, and she's going through the list of, like, ways that you can read this kanji and how, like, it could be interpreted. And she ends up saying Ginyoru, which sends this man into a whole-ass fucking, like, trance. Because the minute you call, the god's posthumous name, you gain control over that god in order to make your wish. And she's not sure what to wish for, so she just says, like, look, I will keep this wish for a while. Fucking bye. And she forgets about it. As you do. Which is... we're also coming
can
to
Can I say something? She... Gin probably shouldn't tell someone the two kanjis to his name.
Well, she already knows that his name is Gin. But, like, he was showing her that Gin kanji, he didn't remember, you know, the other kanji is on his fucking back. Like, she could see that too, dickweed. But she's, like, sitting there, like, riddling it out. But she ends up calling his name. And, you know, entrances him. And she's like, okay, I will keep this wish for later. I don't want to make a wish right now, because what the fuck am I going to wish for? Because you only get one. Because, obviously, if you're fucking calling his name every time you want something done, like, it's going to get overpowered and shit. So, yeah. And that's when, like, shit actually hits the fan. Like, with Yasu related. But not him dying, I swear. I'm not killing this man again.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I can never trust you ever again with this whole Yasu not dying thing.
Yep, basically.
I went into this thinking this man would be alive and you've killed him, like, four times. What the fuck? So, around this time... fucking Mitty's experiencing some really weird changes, and I don't mean puberty, but she's got like a voice in her head. She doesn't know what's going on, but she's got a voice in her head, and Gin doesn't know about this. If he did, he would probably realize the fact that it's his fault. But she's got a voice in her head, and it's all from the different, like, iterations of her fucking around in different timelines that she's not supposed to be in. So, she kind of just brushes it off. She's like, I don't know what this voice is, and I don't really care, to be honest. We're gonna ignore it, like everybody with their mental health. Just brush it under the rug, it's fine.
I have a question, actually.
Mm-hmm?
How come you never wrote this?
Because I wasn't really sure where to start, because there's been so many different iterations of it.
I say you can make a different book for each one of them, because, like, this is actually really cool stuff. Which is the first time I will ever tell you that.
Don't worry, it gets cooler.
I'll have to trust your word.
Don't worry, if I actually write it as a book, which I probably will, because there's a lot here. I'm very motivated now to do that, so I might actually start that later.
Hey, the good thing is, you can scroll through this stream again to know where it's all fitting into place.
Exactly. There's, like, been things that I've obviously missed, because, you know, there's, like, 5 years of content here. But
yeah.
A lot of it is, just the main plot points, because they're the interesting parts. But here is where it gets super fucking interesting. See... okay, let's explain some stuff about my gods, right?
Okay.
So, firstly, a question that I didn't actually answer for a significant period of time, and I didn't really think about it until Georgia questioned me. And she asked me, if Gin's a god, and I'm like, yeah. And she said, if Shinobu is also a god, and I'm like, yeah, he's the god of truth. And she said, is Yoshiko a god as well? And I'm like, no. And she's like, why is that? And I'm like, okay. I've never had to explain this before. But no, Yoshiko is not a god. And no, Ryota is also not a god. Neither is Shiori. And she's like, why? And I'm like, well, because in this canon lore, Yoshiko and Ryota and Shiori, they're not related to Gin. They're not blood, like, anything. They're physically, they're not related in any way. And she's like, how does that work? I'm like, okay. So we know that Shinobu is the god of truth. And he can manipulate people's perceptions of truth, you know, with the fact that he locked away, like, Yasu's memories to keep everybody safe, all that sort of shit. So we know that he can do shit like that. And what he did was, in order to make Gin and the other, and himself blend in better, he manipulated Yoshiko and Ryota and that's memory into thinking that they were related. So he had a family, quote unquote. But they never were, like, in this canon, they weren't related. Because, you know, Yoshiko was human. Which is also, secondarily, the reason why they have different last names in this canon.
I keep forgetting they do have different last names.
Well, technically yes and technically no. Shinobu is a Saito, Ryota is a Saito, Shiori is a Hoshikuse, Yoshiko is a Hoshikuse, and Gin's a Hoshikuse.
Yeah.
Nishishi. In the human canon lore, Gin took the name Hoshikuse to get away from his brother. Mm. That's also why he stopped calling himself Ginyoru. See, everything makes sense.
Again, it really is trying to look at and like, okay, which, like, I have to go back in my memory 3 years ago to remember what you said. And I find it fun. It's like a scavenger hunt, just very mentally torturing.
Memory scavenger hunt. But, okay. So, that's the reason with those things. But, we know that Shinobu is the god of truth.
Yeah.
And that's why he always wears gloves. In every iteration that I draw him with actual hands. Which is not very often. I think I actually forgot to do that in the official manga, but it's okay, because I'm going to rewrite the manga anyways. But, Shinobu wears gloves because he can't control his powers very well. So if he were to make contact with somebody, regardless of whether or not it's Yasu, he will make them spill every lie they've ever told in their entire life. Which has happened in canon, like, twice. Super fun. But then again, in that version of canon where that happened, Gin also froze time to, stuff somebody in a basketball hoop. Was an asshole. He always uses his time manipulation for stupid reasons. But, but we have another god that we just don't fucking talk about very often. And that's my good old-fashioned boyo Ito. Nishishi. Which is also the reason why that motherfucker keeps dying. Told you it would become important. But, Yasu, fuck off Yasu. Stop living in my head rent-free. Fucking, Ito is the god of light. And in order for him to bring the sun down, he has to die. So he dies at the end of every day. And then he, you know, is reborn like a fucking phoenix every morning to rise the sun with him. Which I actually like. One of my favorite parts about my canon. I wanted an actual reason to make this motherfucker keep dying. I actually really like that. He's a sunshine child. Literally. But he doesn't really have a lot of, like, powers. Mainly he has healing. He heals people. He is the healer class. But other than that, he doesn't really have a lot of things that he can do. So he's kind of useless, to be honest. I love you, Ito, but you don't really do much, buddy. You just sit and heal Gin's blight 90% of the fucking time. And another interesting thing about guns is specifically gin, because I don't think I really gave anybody else these, or at least nothing super important. But I gave them things called shinky.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, interesting. New terminology. There will be a lot of that.
I would like to mention something. My phone is at 18%.
Oh, rip.
So, heads up.
Yeah, I'll try and be quick. Shinky are, like, they're weapons, mainly. And they have their own, like, consciousness and shit. Because they're... How do I describe Shinky very well? They're, like, undead people, but not... They Makes take sense. The form of different weapons. This is why Gin has a scythe. And his mask is also a shinky.
Mm.
His mask is a navigation thing. And in his own words, which happen to be, he says this a lot, it's mainly, I wouldn't look like much of a god if I took the mask off, because I just look like a normal person. And I'd rather not look like a human, gross. He really hates people. But he has several shinky. He has his scythe, he has his mask, and he has a bracelet, I believe. And he uses these to, hunt phantoms and shit, mainly. But in one event, he was fighting said, shinky, and Mitty was in the middle of the fight. And she got pretty fucking busted up, pretty injured. And when he took Mitty back to, the shrine to, heal her and shit. Because Gin can't heal. Gin can't heal for shit. He literally doesn't know how to. He doesn't have that ability. But Shinobu does. So he was with Shinobu and he was with Ito. Ito, fucking Yasu. Now Ito's living in my head right quick. Fuck's sake. Yasu, I actually want you for now.
It's a merry-go-round.
Motherfucker is never there when you need him. Always there when you don't want him, though.
Accurate.
But in trying to heal Mitty, Shinobu had to take off his gloves. And he ended up accidentally running into Yasu instead. Which, surprise, surprise, was not a good fucking thing. Because this gave Yasu all of his memories of being a god of calamity back. Which is super. The reason why we lock those fucking things away in the first place, because he can't fucking control them. He's a chaotic bitch. And in doing so, he went on a rampage. He literally went on a rampage, destroying most of Tokyo and most of Kyoto because, it sucks.
Dante asked why this reminded him of an isekai.
Rip. So, in this, whole thing, Gin really only had one choice. He had to abolish this timeline. But it's one of those things that he couldn't do on his own. He can he can change the timeline, but eventually this timeline was still going to happen regardless. He had to destroy the whole timeline completely. And the only way to do that was to enlist the help of another god, which is not going to be Ito for once. Because he can't do shit in this situation. And thus, he called on probably just his least favorite person in, ever, which is Izanami. If you don't know who Izanami is the goddess of the underworld.
I think that's actually an actual name of a god.
It is. I googled it.
plagiarism at its finest.
Plagiarism if it's an actual thing.
Yeah. Wasn't Yabusa an actual thing?
No.
Yes, he was. He's in the anime. That counts.
Anyways, ignoring that whole promiscuous event.
I'm trying to be quieter. I've been really loud. I don't want to wake Mama up.
So he ends up calling on Iza. Aggressively, actually, he demands that she abolish the timeline, because she's the only one that can actually destroy timelines. He can't do that. He can only change them. So he demands that she destroy the timeline. And in return, she'll give him his name. Which is a big fucking thing in the God world. Because your name is everything you have going for you. So if Gin were to give her his name, he would be stuck in the underworld with her. But everybody else would be pretty safe. Because, you know, Yasu's memories would be locked up again and he wouldn't be going on a fucking rampage like an angry teenager. Yasu, stop destroying Kyoto, it's your PMS. So Izanami accepts, but while, like, this is happening, because he's not being fucking subtle about it, like, because, you know, the timeline's about to be destroyed anyways. What is the point in keeping your secret identity secret? So, he's doing this from the top of a hotel, like, the roof of a fucking hotel. And Mitty is watching him from the ground. Mitty's watching him from the ground, and it was actually a really cool, like, scene, and I would honestly love to write it in the manga, but it'd be, like, really fucking hard, because this giant skeleton lady, and I mean giant skeleton lady, like, she was fucking huge, at least, like, twice the size of said hotel, ascends from the fucking ground and just grabs this dude, and she's like, fuck yeah, I got a collectible. And she sinks back down, and Mitty's like, what the fuck? But she leaves her portal open, which is a dumb idea, because Mitty is a dumb bitch and she will go after her. So Mitty ends up, you know, falling down said portal. And she can't find Gin anywhere. Well, obviously, because Gin's been put in, you know, solitary confinement. He's been a bad boy. But he's been put in, like, a confinement chamber. And the only people that are there when Mitty lands is just her and Izanami. And Izanami doesn't even know who this bitch is. She's like, first of all, how the fuck did you get here? Second of all, hi! What up, girly? They're like best friends. They should not be best friends. Mitty needs better friends. She's dating a horrible human being, and she's best friends with the goddess of the underworld. Like, pick your fucking struggles. But she ends up talking with Izanami. And the only way to get Gin back, or Gin's name back specifically, is for Mitty to offer Izanami something in return. And Mitty's like, I don't have anything. I am a weak as piss human. What the fuck do you want from me, Izanami? Like, bro, I have nothing to offer you. And she sits there and she thinks and she says, you have your humanity. I can take that. And Mitty's like, what the fuck does that mean? And she said, just that. I will take your remaining humanity. And Mitty's like, oh, fuck, am I gonna die? Am I gonna literally die to save this stupid idiot friend of my fuck me? And she's like, fine, I will give you my humanity. And she does. But not in the way that you'd think. She doesn't end up dying or anything. But she essentially gives away her living life. So Mitty now, as of any canon after this, where God is Gin is a god, goddess again. In any remaining canon after that, she can't have kids, she can't get sick, she can't die, she can't do anything like that because she's not living anymore. But she's not really dead. She's like a weird mix. She also can't feel like any sort of weather like changes. She can't feel hot, she can't feel cold, she can't do any of that. But in doing so, when she sells this humanity, her soul splits. Because, you know, her soul was already split because she had that voice in her head. And thus, we get the glory known as fucking Miyako. I love her. But she sucks. Miyako's a bitch. Miyako's a fucking total bitch. She's the one with the white hair.
You like all the characters that are a total bitch.
I do. I really do. She's super cool. But she's basically the exact opposite of what Mitty was. She was a bitch, because Mitty was pretty sweet and nice and shit, and Mitty, like, and fucking Miyako just sucks. But Miyako gets sent back down to where Gin is, who's in solitary confinement because he's a naughty boy. But she ends up being sent down to him. And Gin's not having a good fucking time. He has been punctured by, like, a inglorious spear because he fell wrong. He literally, it was just bad timing. He literally just fell incorrectly and ended up landing on a spear, poor bastard. But it pierced, like, directly through his name. So, Ripperoony familiar. And he has no idea that this entire conversation with Izanami and Mitsui is even taking place. He would discourage against it, because why the fuck would you do that? Stop talking to the goddess of the underworld, please, Mitsui, you fucking dumb bitch. But, you know, she's not going to do that, and Gin ends up unintentionally being saved. And he didn't even want to be. But in order to sell her humanity to Izanami, you have to eat Izanami's fruit. It's very reminiscent of Persephone in Hades,
mm-hmm.
where Persephone ate three.
I think it was three.
She ate several pomegranate seeds.
Yeah.
To spend that amount, like, of months with Hades. It's very reminiscent of that. You eat Izanami's fruit, you give away humanity. It's pretty similar. You're not supposed to eat Izanami's food.
It's the equivalent of, hey, can I copy your homework? No, yeah, just don't make it obvious.
Yeah, it's fruit instead. So she eats her, she eats the, fucking strawberry, and she loses her humanity, you know. It's not like any good girl. She lost her life virginity.
Don't say it like that. That's all I can say. Don't say that.
Please go with it. So they end up being sent back, and they get sent back into this newer timeline where Yasu's actually in control of his powers now. He hasn't forgotten any of them anymore, but he is in better control. But we don't like it when that happens. We don't like things being normal. Disgusting. This is ATD. We don't do normality here. So, not a lot happens for a while. Miyako, you know, befriends a bunch of, like, Gin's god friends, because Gin has friends, apparently, that aren't Yasu.
Unrealistic.
Unrealistic expectations. Gin can't make friends. He sucks.
No,
but
he
it
doesn't.
Comes to that standstill where Gin knows what's gonna happen next. Which sucks. But, you know, he's entered a weird sort of relationship with Miyako. Like, they're not exactly dating, but they're not exactly not. He's got some sort of weird emotional attachment to this.
What year did you make this part?
We finished, because we're close to the end of that original God timeline. We finished it at about 2018, I think.
When did you date Midi?
2019? Don't worry, we're actually super close to, like, the end. I promise.
No, it's fine. That's not what I was wondering, because I was thinking... The more you bring up, like, things, like, with dating something similar to Midi, or, like, just another version of Midi, I'm like, okay, when did he make this? It's self-insert fanfictions.
Very ironic. But, yeah, like, Gin knows what's gonna happen next. And it's not gonna be good. Because yeah. Yasu still needs to die. So does Aito.
When is it ever good?
But, yeah, it's... This dude and dying, man, he needs to stop. But it's still in the natural law that he needs to die. And obviously Mitty doesn't want to see that, and obviously Gin doesn't want to see that shit either. So he has a small breakdown, because, you know, it's Gin.
Yep.
And he freaks out. Like, he full-on freaks out. And Mitty's questioning what's going on. And he tells her, look... This is how things have to go. Yasu needs to die. And I don't want to watch Yasu die. And you don't want to watch Yasu die. Because, you know, you're in love with Yasu, aren't you? And I don't want to see Miyako die. Fucking Ripperoni. But she also... She's gonna die eventually. And... his ultimatum is to end the world. Which sounds super fucking edgy now that I'm saying it out loud.
I was about to say, slight overreaction, so.
No, he doesn't actually, he doesn't really end the world. Like, that's not exactly what happened. He just, he knows, the reason Gin can't die is because the way that these gods work is as long as you, humans believe that whatever that god is controlling is going to happen, it will happen. There will be a god for it. Like Aizato. He dies at the end of every day. But since everybody already consciously knows that the sun is always going to rise the next day, he will always come back.
Sounds about right.
Exactly. As long as, people still believe in time, because there's no way you can't believe in time. You know time is going to pass. As long as you believe that time is going to pass, Gin can't officially die. He just keeps coming back.
That explains why you can't die.
Yeah, as long as you still believe in war, Yasuo is going to come back. As long as people are still lying, Shinobu will always come back.
That was a really shitty... That's pretty much how. I don't think you understood my really shitty joke, and you don't have to. And you never will, so...
I didn't hear it.
Oh my god. I just died. I don't know where my stuff is.
Oh no!
Wait! I was mining for levels so I can enchant my bow.
Rip. The bow fall back.
I got blown up by a creeper.
Oh, that sucks.
I'm not wearing my headphones, so I didn't hear it. I didn't mean to interrupt you by magically freaking out.
That's okay. I believe that you'll be able to find it.
I got 5 minutes. Don't.
I believe in
you. Don't moan like that.
So, anyways. Gin's ultimatum is to speed up time. Exponentially. Like, just pretty much end the world by speeding up time to the point where nothing is left. And he knows that eventually, the world is going to rekindle itself. It's not going to end completely. So he will be back, but he's freaking out because he knows that there's probably no chance that Miyako is also going to make it back. If he ends the world now, he loses her, and he loses pretty much everybody else as well. But his ultimatum is he doesn't want to watch his friends die again. He's had pretty much an eternity of watching that shit. He doesn't want to see it again. And he doesn't want Mitsui to have to say the same thing, because now she's immortal and she won't die either. So he's like, no, I don't want to do this. This is his ultimatum. Like, I don't want to have to do this shit. So Mitsui calls him by his name. And she says, Ginyoru. And in doing so, she charms him. And now he has to oblige by whatever wish she makes. And she ends up wishing for him to end the world. To just do it. And, she will lose everything as well. Because once all the humans die, then fucking Yasuo will also die, because there's no one to cause war. So she's gonna lose him too. Everyone's gonna fucking die. So now the wish has been made, and he has to oblige by it, and he has to do it because it's what he's made for. And he does, and he ends up destroying everything. And the last three people that are left in the crumbling of the broken world, there's nothing left but Gin, Mitsui, and Aito. And Aito's only there to bring the sun down one more time before he dies as well. It's just a super depressing ending.
Yes.
Gin's going to be the last thing left. And so he turns to Mitsui and he's kind of joking, but he says, so, we're the last two people left. Want to get married? It's just like, you know what? Fuck it. Might as well. So now we have a new joke of the fact that they never actually got married, but the fact that they never actually were broken up. But that timeline ends up completely shattered. It ends up broken. It's gone. And for a while, nothing happens. Until the world starts up again, and Gin starts up again, and he's back, motherfucker. Because he can't fucking die. But when he comes back, he has all these memories. And of course, since he's back and time's restarting again, Mitzi's back, and so are all the other gods. But this whole timeline is so much more different, because Miyako obviously isn't going to be there. And to be honest, neither is Yoshiko or fucking Ryota or anything like that. Any of the humans that we had before are gone. Like, Mitsu's prior, boyfriend, Kisei, he's gone as well, he's dead. We have a whole new cast of people, including Sam. That motherfucker is living. Fucking love that stupid little bitch. I love him so much. But that's when, the original timeline ends. And we're, back with Samuel. The boy, where things get a bit, less confusing, but more confusing at the same time. Because we get the introduction of the Essex rooms. That was actually not intentional. I did not plan on doing that, but Essex rooms are cool. And you also get Marthu, who's a dope little dude. He's a fucking angel. Which is where the manga starts, because the manga starts through that same lens. The manga Gin that we see now in the official ATD manga is the Gin that happens after all of this shit. Which is where he's starting off looking for Mafuyu, the fucking angel, and that's when Sam meets him. Because he's looking for this stupid little angel boy, but he can't find this stupid little angel boy. He knows that this stupid little angel boy is in that school, but he can't fucking find him because he's too stupid. Fucking dumb Gin. Oh no! Dumb Gin fucking knowledge here. But, while he's looking for Mafia, he's entering Essex rooms. And essentially, an Essex room is pretty much... You can find an Essex room anywhere in the human world that there's a door. Which is, again, probably one of my favorite parts about this entire, franchise is the Essex rooms. Because it was unintentional. I made it on a whim, and I ended up really liking it. But these Essex rooms are, they're basically the same. They look the same as the human room. You get these, every god has a skeleton key, and if they use that skeleton key in any door, literally any door, anywhere, you'll enter the Essex room version of that door, which is where all of your, spiritual things are. You can find demons in there, you can find angels in there, you can find literally anything that isn't human hanging out in this Essex room. But to get to the Essex room, you need one of these keys. So Gin's looking around at all the fucking Essex rooms of, this school, trying to find this fucking angel. And he's just not having a good time. And Sam ends up following him and going into one of the Essex rooms, which is a horrible decision. You should never take a human into an Essex room because, they'll get fucking eaten. Sam's friend almost gets fucking eaten. He's a dumb motherfucker, man. He's literally the dumbest rocks. But while he's, he ends up, Gin takes Sam out of the Essex room. He's like, bro, what the fuck? Leave. So Sam finds out really fucking quickly that Gin's a god. Because again, Gin has never fucking hidden this. If you ask him, he will tell you. It's just people don't believe him. He's really not trying to hide anything. So Sam finds out really, quickly that this dumb motherfucker is actually a god. And he's like, okay, that's cool. I'm fascinated. I'm always here for some non-human action because I'm fucking bored of my life. Being a human sucks ass. So he's trying to, follow Gin around. And Gin ends up leaving where Sam is. Sam's at the library. And Gin was looking in the Essex rooms in the library. So, Gin leaves and Sam gets bored again, you know, as he does, because he's bored. And he thinks, like, yeah, my life's gonna go back to normal. That was a one-time thing. That's never gonna happen again. Flies. And then a book flies. A book just shoots off the fucking bookshelf halfway across the fucking room. And Sam's the only one in the library and he freaks the fuck out. He's like, what the fuck was that? So he goes over to this book and he's like, okay, the fuck just happened? Why the fuck did a book just fly off? And the book opens and he's like, okay, that's some spooky shit. I don't like this. And while this book is opening, like, the pages are flipping and shit, and a fucking hand just comes out of this book, and Sam flips his shit. He's freaking the fuck out. He's like, what the fuck is happening? I'm so confused. He doesn't know what's going on. But this hand ends up belonging to Mafuyu, the little angel boy, who was hiding in a book this whole time, because he doesn't want to be found. He quirky. He literally is, like, the worst. Gin loses this angel so many times because he's bored. He doesn't want to hang around with fucking gods and shit. He wants humans. But he ends up, like, giving Mafuyu back to Gin, and Gin disappears. And Gin disappears for a long time. Like, long enough for Sam to become an adult and shit and start working with his mother's, like, fashion industry and shit. Because his mother sucked. We hate Sam's parents. Parents in ATD just aren't good. So, it takes him a while, but eventually Gin's out looking for Mafuyu again, because, you know, motherfucker's hiding in books again. Because he's bored. He's like a teenager, he doesn't know what to do. So, once again, Sam didn't even realize, because he's working at a fashion industry now, he didn't even realize that Mafuyu had gotten into his office, and he was hiding in one of the fucking books again. Because he likes Sam. He's taken interest in a human. Not romantically, he's just very bored of his own life. So, Gin's once again looking for this stupid little angel boy, and comes across Sam again. And Sam thinks that everything that happened when he was a teenager was just completely fake. Like, it was a dream, he dreamt it up, it wasn't real. Until he's face to face with this stupid little god man again. And he's like, you have got to be fucking kidding me. He is real, god damn it. Like, he went to therapy and shit to convince himself that it wasn't real, and now he's back, and he's like, ah, thanks. Now I'm gonna need to go to therapy again. Fuck you. But, like, they end up finding each other, and Mafuyu ends up coming out of the book because he's bored. Best way to sum up Mafuyu's entire character is he was bored. But he ends up coming out of the book, and Sam, being Sam, he's like, hey, you're really fucking pretty. You should totally be one of my models. Which was probably the funniest thing I think I've ever read in the entirety of making the ATD timeline, was making Gin, the god of time, into a model for a fashion magazine.
Can I tell you something? I am still listening, I will tell you this. But I may have a problem. I've died 4 times.
Oof.
I don't know if I can get all my stuff back, and I'm freaking out.
It's okay. I believe in you.
Why am I mentally breaking down over Minecraft?
Because you've had a lot of emotional things today.
It's also because I worked hard on that gear. So I'm just making boats and trapping the mobs in that keep trying to kill me because I have to rush back down to get it. Anyway, keep going.
So, Gin ends up accepting, which is probably the dumbest move I think this man has ever made.
You sure?
It doesn't really lead anywhere, but he ends up being a model for this fucking thing. Which sucks for him. Because now he's seeing a lot of Sam. And he didn't want to see a lot of Sam. He literally, he at this point, he fucking hates humans. He despises humans because he lost Miyako. So he doesn't want anything to do with humans. He's super fucking mean, and he sucks. But Sam has taken a liking to Gin. He really likes Gin, which is horrible choosing. Why would you choose to like Gin? Gin sucks. Why do people like me?
Don't ask me that.
So, he ends up seeing a lot of Sam. Like, a lot of Sam. And he doesn't want to. He really doesn't want to. But he has to. And they end up getting somewhat close. Not as close as Sam would like to be, because, you know, Sam wants this man's booty. But Gin is not willing to provide with their booty. But eventually they end up seeing way, way too much of each other, and Gin gets really oddly attached to this man. He doesn't know why. He's super pissed off about it, actually. And he doesn't want anything to do with humans anyways, but he doesn't. It's okay.
No, I think I genuinely lost all my gear. Give me a second. I'm still listening, don't worry. Just give me a second before you continue. I worked so hard to get those diamonds.
That was 16 diamonds!
I love the stages of grief just now.
Who's fucking 16 diamonds? Son of a bitch!
I'm gonna go hang out with my parents to make me feel better. Parrot Shizu. Okay, now you can continue.
Okay. So Gin ends up being, like, oddly attached to this man. And he doesn't do anything about it because he doesn't do anything about it until Sam's birthday. And he doesn't realize that it's Sam's birthday. But, Sam's parents come over. And, okay, we don't like them. We don't like parents in ATD. Unless they're Aito's parents, we don't care for them. So, he doesn't even realize that it's Sam's birthday until his parents come over. And he hears Sam's dad say, oh, it's his birthday, like, leave him alone or something to his mother. Because his mother's a bitch. But Gin's like, fuck, birthdays are important events to humans. Ew, gross, should I do something for him? And he doesn't know what to do, he's dumb. But he does like showing off. As a gift. And so he thinks, alright.
The best present is sex.
He thinks, I'll do a magic show. Because I don't like this. I don't like this lady. Fuck this woman. Sam's mum. Gross. Disgusting. So he thinks, I'll do a magic show just to, you know, shut her the fuck up. And impress everybody else because he's a giant show off. So he uses said sleight of hand magic tricks. And, you know, actual magic, because he's a god. To, like, just do a bunch of, like, random things, like, he brushes his hand against, like, fucking Sam's mum's, like, ear and shit and pulls a bottle of wine from it, like, he just does some stupid shit. You know, just to show off and put her in a place. But he takes a glass, like, he fills a glass with wine, with the same wine that he pulls from her fucking ear. Fills a glass with wine, waves his hand over it, and the glass turns into a necklace. It's just this plain, like, gold, like, chain necklace. And he gives it to Sam for his birthday. And Sam doesn't know what the fuck this means. And this is a big thing. Especially for Gin. But he doesn't know what it means, and he goes and has dinner with his parents and shit, and now he has lunch with his parents, and Gin offers to take him out to dinner. And when he does take him out to dinner, he takes him to, like, Tasmania or some shit. It's called the end of the world. Like, the edge of the world. And he takes him there, because teleportation privileges. God privileges. there, and they had, like, dinner, or at least they had us in, can't digest food. But they have dinner there, and Sam asks him what the deal with the necklace is, and Gin flicks, like, his neck, and he gets the same necklace. And Sam's like, okay, now I'm even more confused, what's with the necklace? And Gin says, it's kind of like entwining our fates. Everything that that happens to you now will now affect me in some sort of way. Like, if you're in danger, I will pretty much be forced to come to your aid. And it's like, it's a red string of fate. In a more literal sense, which is why I drew them recently with the red string of fate necklaces. But he entwined his fate with Sam's, which was a big thing for him because he didn't even do that shit with Miyako. Mainly because I wasn't thinking that would be the thing to do, because it wasn't something that was in my brain up until then.
I don't know.
It just kind of came out. But he entwined his fate with him, and that ended up, like, coming with a bunch of different consequences, but none of which were really important. But thinking. It's been a while since I've done this timeline. I gotta think about what actually happened. I know that not a lot happened, though. Like, Gin has a run-in with an angel, like an angel knight, and he kind of sucks, but he's not horrible. He's pretty nice. He adopts a fucking angel, like a fallen angel girl, which ironically her name is Aya. She was cool. There's a lot of angels in this story. And nothing really happens up until, like, Luca comes back. We like Luca. Luca is one of Sam's friends. And Gin didn't know originally that Luca was just a friend of his. So he got super jealous of, like, Sam's attention being taken away from him. You know, the god for a shitty little human. He was super mad about it. And it's the first and only event of Gin trying to eat something.
Really?
And the consequences that he throws it up because he can't. He doesn't have a working digestive tract. Because it's all for show. He doesn't really have any organs. He doesn't have a heart. He doesn't have, like, anything. Everything is just for show. Just for decoration. He doesn't even bleed. He bleeds ink, which is the whole joke about the ink thing. But, so, Luca ends up complimenting Sam's cooking, and it irks the shit out of Gin, because he's like, alright, fuck you, I'm gonna try his cooking, and he tries his cooking, and he just ends up throwing it up. The super emotional, like, scene between those two was really cute, because Gin was like, I wanna eat with you too, and it was really cute and wholesome.
I think I just hit a puffer fish.
Hmm?
I think I just hit a puffer fish, because I almost lost all my hearts.
Oh, no.
I'm having a good time from the stories, but, like, playing-wise, I'm not having a good time.
Sorry. We're pretty much at the end of the story, to be honest.
Well, that's good, not because it's the end, but because my phone's at 10%.
Yeah, I told you I'd try and be quick.
And thankfully, if I forgot anything, I can just come back here.
But pretty much, like, that's really all that we had so far, like... Like, we'll end up doing, like, other storylines as we go along. Like, human Gin will probably make a comeback, or, like, God Gin will make a comeback. And, like, the story will keep going, but canonically, that's all we have so far.
I have a question.
Mm-hmm?
You know how the date I chose is June 1st?
Mm-hmm.
Am I ever allowed to change that?
Go ahead.
I don't know why I would change it, too. God damn it, three of my chickens got out. I'll let you be free, you little bitches. I'm not in the mood. No, but it's making me, like, your stuff is making me a lot more confident. Not because it's bad, but because it's just you're passionate about it, is a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Life lessons. What is this fucking My Little Pony? But still. You can be an idiot.
Do you have any questions about the actual story?
Not at the moment, because, like, it's... I'll probably re-listen to this thing and then ask.
Yay! Again, I missed out, like, a whole bunch, but a lot of it was just, like, kind of filler.
Yeah, how about... Okay, we're gonna play somewhere near April from March 30th or 31st to April 4th, somewhere wherever you choose. How about we do it... April 9th.
April 9th?
Yeah. My time.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because, funny enough, I don't think that's... It's either, I would like to say this, I just really like that date for some reason. It's either one of my characters' birthdays, or it's Doggy's birthday, and I don't remember why I chose April 9th. I just like April 9th. No, but yeah, It's really creative is the thing. Like, you don't have to make a manga outfit, but I think you definitely should write it. I just realized I lost all my foods as well.
RIP.
I have a farm, but like... I'm just staring at my screen and realizing everything I lost. My unbreaking axe and my efficiency pickaxe. Level 2.
RIP.
I hate Minecraft. No. I still had a lot of fun.
That's such a mood.
Yeah, but...
One thing doesn't make my way. I hate it.
No, yeah, but this has made me a lot more confident.
Good.
Hey. My mom
it's been so long since I've just sat there and, like, fucking went over the whole ATD timeline. Holy shit.
I'm happy I got to listen to it, though. And hopefully Shizu got to listen to it, too. Also, Dante.
Don't worry. When I write it, I'll include everything.
Yay.
But I am super tempted to actually write it now.
No, yeah, I have a bit of boost of confidence now, so I kind of want to get mine over with.
Do it!
Because there's also a lot.
Oh, man.
Because it goes... I realized how far back I planned. I was like, oh, shit. There's so much backstory. Why do I like backstory the best?
Oh, man. The funny thing is, like, for the longest time, Gin didn't have a backstory.
You did tell me this.
Yeah, he didn't. He literally didn't. He didn't have shit.
Of course it's been 2 hours, Dante. That's how streams work.
My god, it's only been 2 hours. I thought it would be longer.
I don't know what I'm gonna do for my stream. Am I just gonna play Minecraft and fail it? I did say this title is failing at Minecraft. I predicted my own future. But what I was gonna say is, I don't know what I'm gonna do for mine. Because I don't really want to focus on a game for me to talk.
I mean...
But I don't want it to be a black screen either.
I could draw, I guess. I've been drawing this entire time, by the way.
You have?
Yeah.
That explains why you haven't seen all my shenanigans.
I haven't seen a lot of it.
If you look at my stream, there's just a time where I do the same thing, except one time I decide to make a bunch of boats.
I did see that. I looked up and saw all the boats, and I was like, what is she doing?
No, but the thing is, boats don't despawn, because they're placed. So now there's just, in the cave, an area with a bunch of boats with zombies in them. And those zombies have some of my armor and my bow.
That's my goal right there.
But I lost my diamond armor and my diamond weapons, which is the main thing.
It's depressing as shit, man.
No, but yeah, if you want to draw, that'd be fine. No, we could just Discord call since Instagram would not work for screen sharing on a stream. Oh, wait. Have you seen it? Look.
Hmm?
Look up. My parrot.
Your parrot. They're laughing.
But look at the name.
I can't see the name.
Well, wait till the stream catches up.
Where are we now? Okay, the stream is that you talking, like, and saying, do you, like, if you want to draw. So, give it a minute.
I'm sorry. I'll walk up to the parrot eventually. Until I accidentally click on it. I clicked on it. Stop. You're next to Yazoo. And then we have parrot Yazoo.
Yay!
I accidentally clicked on the goddamn parrot. I was about to fly out the window.
Yeah. Yeah, I've been drawing, like, literally this whole time.
What are you drawing?
I've drawn, like, I drew Yasuo again, and then I drew, like, a sword kind of thing.
Just a sword?
When we were talking about Shinkies, I was, like, drawing, like, Yasuo's hand and Gin's hand with a katana.
I like that parrot Yasuo. It's up one step.
Long live the king.
Superiority complex, even with parrots.
What do
I do? I don't know what to name the last parrot. At least I kept the name tag for that one. At least I have my enchanting table and my jukebox. I didn't lose everything. I just now only have one diamond.
Give it anxiety.
Wait, it is blue. I will do that later. I must now.
It's necessary.
It's necessary for the process. Wait, can you breed birds?
I don't know. I think you can. I don't see any reason why you wouldn't be able to.
But you can breed bees.
Can breed bees? I love that.
Yeah, the achievement's literally called the parrot and the bees. Or like...
Oh no. Birds and the bees.
Yeah. That's the first time I got that achievement is because I ran into a hive and picked up some flowers and bred two bees. I will make a swarm of bees to fight the wither.
Oh, I haven't played Minecraft in so long. I haven't picked up my Switch in so long.
I wish I could play with you.
I, honestly, I've been doing just literally anything else.
Dante said, I'm hungry yet confused.
Why are you confused, my guy? Is it ATD related or Minecraft related? Or neither, and you are confused or something else.
To explain, I want to breed parrot again and shoot a note.
In some universe.
I am really excited now to explain mine, because I do get to mention you, because you technically canonically exist.
Yay!
You canonically exist in the chat room stuff, and then there's the shadow version of you.
Bro, could you imagine Hiromi in ATD?
Please, no.
That would be fucking... Trip.
I can't handle him dying. Sakura, sure, I already killed her, but...
I never said I was gonna kill him!
You kill, like, everyone!
She's never gonna forgive the fact that I killed Yasuo.
Name one character you have not killed.
Gin! Oh, wait, no!
I was about to say, I've been paying attention, he does die!
I'm, like, remembering the part where, because there's a scene when Gin takes Mitzi to America. It's not all that important, but, well, it kind of is. When they get back from America, that's when the Izan Army shit happens. But, fucking, he takes Mitzi to America because he can speak English and Yasuo can't. Canonically, Yasuo could not speak English, which is so funny, because now, after, like, developing him for so long, now he can, but English was his hardest language to learn. But, fucking, Mitzi's just vibing, and then Gin had changed too much shit in the timeline, and he just fucking explodes into ink, and Mitzi's like, what the fuck? Did my pet god just die? And he comes back in, like, he walks in through the door, because, you know, when he explodes into ink, he gets sent back to his original quote-unquote form, which is a fucking toddler. So we get toddler Gin getting really fucking angry at the fact that he died.
No, but, like, I think you mentioned somewhere else that he died. I was like, yeah, Gin fucking die. Wait, I think I know a character that doesn't die.
Mm-hmm.
It's either Yoshiko or Shinobu.
True. Well, technically, we go on the Gon timeline where, like, where Gin destroys the world, they both technically die.
Okay, then you think of a person that doesn't die.
Yeah.
Exactly! Wait, does Izanami die?
Izanami technically wasn't really living, but she would have turned to dust, yeah. When the world ended, she would have turned to dust.
See, this is why my characters aren't going to ATD.
Everyone died.
The other problem with that is that Shima and Sakura are very different characters from my other ones out of my 123. It's both that they're both, other than Shima and Sakura, both been my favorites, since that does have some lore implications, is that they're both, because of the chat room, they're both very self-aware of their existence, but they aren't gods either, because they're below me, so it would be kind of weird for them to know everything, but still just be humans.
Yeah, the temptation to, like, add, like, if I ever wrote, like, a full ATD manga, like, with everything in it, I would want to do a crossover with your characters so badly.
If you make, like, another timeline, then, like, fine.
Well, I mean, every timeline exists at the same time with this man, that's the point! That's how Gin can have, like, be fucking Andy in one timeline, but married to Sam in the other timeline, but be, like, engaged to Hiromi in one timeline, but be fucking Miyako in another one.
This
is what I mean by, like, I can uproot this character, like, Gin, and Dante put him in any situation.
Dante says
it still makes sense.
Dante says some of his characters are in ATD.
Yes.
But I think, like, depending on how the story would go, I would agree to some of my characters being in ATD. Because some of them would actually make sense with, like, Sakura and Shima, since they were both one of my favorite characters at the time, which, again, lore implications. And then there's the characters that are loosely based off you, like Akiyoshi and Hayaka, and, like, the characters that were influenced by you, like everyone in Bungo Stray Dogs. Which I'm really excited to talk about, because I only briefly mentioned it in your birthday present.
See, the cool thing about it is, I could do an ATD crossover, but it could be with a human Gin.
Oh, that is fair.
Technically, in a way, I have done an ATD crossover with you, because I did the fucking Tokyo Rainy Season.
Oh, wait, that counts?
Well, yeah, I guess. Kind of. It depends, because, like, Kanra Gin is different to Canon Gin.
Yeah, we know that.
So, I kind of separate ATD and the chat room a lot. Mainly because the stories are just super different.
That's the difference between my characters. It's canonical that Shima and Sakura went through the chat room thing. And when you said the thing in Tokyo for Rainy Season with Sakura calling Shima to say, trust me, this guy's a riot, that wasn't actually what I had in mind for when she met the chat room. But I did change it because I'm like, okay, I have to stick to this. I really want this now.
Honestly, I couldn't really think about why the fuck, like, Hiromi would have actually, like, joined.
No, but you're
Sakura
very...
You're around Gin, so I'm like, maybe it was her fault?
You're very close to what happened. I'm gonna briefly explain it, but I'll go into more detail when we do my stream. Basically, what Sakura did is she appeared out fucking nowhere. Which is a thing she likes to do when she's too lazy to just buy a train ticket or walk. And she told her brother, basically, this was a place where she didn't have to worry about something that I'm not gonna tell you yet, and where...
Okay, the chat room technically non-canon. It's non-canon to ATD, at least. It's like a separate universe using similar characters. Continue?
And basically, Sakura was saying, it's a way for her to escape her problems and escape the stress of me. And for Shima, it would be a way for him to escape his anxiety and be a person he would rather be, like someone more confident.
And then he met Gin, and his anxiety shot through the fucking roof again.
No, yeah, in like his actual world, yeah, but I'm gonna mention this briefly, but it's basically something I called, and it's a plot device, because that's all I use, plot devices. Is the establishment of personality, which basically means whatever personalities they show first off in the chat, which Shima's first one with a tsundere, that's the one they'll be stuck with the entire time they're in the chat, unless I decide to get rid of it, or basically, well, yeah, that's basically it.
Yeah, which is what you did do.
Yeah, they don't have a choice, basically. So, like, Shima can still think, like, his actual thoughts, because I'm pretty sure, if I were to say this canonically, every time you were flirting with him, he was definitely freaking out. But, yeah, they wouldn't have a choice on how they act, so that's why Sakura was much more, I'm gonna say, explosive, and and Shima was much more moody. Yeah, I have most of the stuff planned out. It's the main story stuff. It's a lot of them are side stories depending on what series I chose. Like, certain, like, with Slice of Life shit, I can't do shit with that. And even with that, Kurosha Tsuji barely had anything that connected together. There was a lot of arcs. The only one that would make sense to have a connecting timeline is Monica Magica, somewhat Dakuretai. There are, and I guess Dialogue Lovers, it's a really heavy maybe.
Lovers.
I don't want to talk about Dialogue Lovers, honestly. why'd I add it? It's straight shit.
It's been a hot minute since I last heard that name.
There was two things I think you're gonna hate, Dialogue Lovers and Dakuretai.
I'm curious.
Dakuretai is a train wreck.
It's a train wreck in canon lore, anyways.
Yes, but it's like a semi-truck got ran into by a train. The semi-truck is the canon Dakuretai. The train is something very, very, very different from Dakuretai.
You are making me more curious.
Sadly, my phone is at 7%, so we can't talk about it in this stream. But I'm happy to get you curious is the thing, because that's what you do with me, made me curious. So I was worried that you wouldn't find it as interesting because it's just fan fiction.
Oh no, I'm like super curious.
Yeah, the only one who has a canonical story that technically isn't fan fiction would be Shima, which is based around his entire relationship with Akiyoshi.
Shima is a lad, I love him.
That's
king.
That's the first time you've said Shima. You mostly call him Hiromi.
It feels weird.
Funny enough, Sophia said, it's funny, you don't call your character by his actual name. I'm like, it sounds fucking weird now.
Yeah, it sounds weird calling him Shima. Hiromi! Never mind, I hate that. Never gonna call him Hiromi again.
No, yeah, but I am excited to talk about it, since there's a lot of canon stuff, and then there's a lot of canon, but not never gonna be published stuff, but still technically is all going at the same time.
Yeah.
It's close to what you did. All the timelines are still working at the same time.
Yeah.
So the problem with that is, since I have way more than you, for every anime or video game, because apparently there's one video game in there and it's Undertale.
Yeah.
There's one timeline. So, okay, Kurosha Tsuji, Durara, Oron, Undertale, Dakuretai, technically Fate Grand Order. Diabolic Lovers, Monica Magica plus Magia Record, Death Note, Attack on Titan, Sakaiichi plus Junjo, Bungo Stray Dogs, My Hero Academia. There's a lot.
I mean, it just means that I will have, like, a nice amount of time to sit and listen for this.
There is I counted 14 of those. Most of them, also Pokemon, so 15. But most of them don't matter, and then there's ones that have somewhat story, some don't, and then, well, that's most of them, somewhat story, some don't. I'm excited for the Bungo Stray Dogs stuff, too, though.
Yeah.
Because I get to make heavy references to you and Shizu. Anyway, my phone is at 6%. Oof.
I mean, a good thing, because I've finished explaining everything.
Yeah, sorry, I was just, I was getting caught up in my stuff. We'll have to wait till April 9th.
I'm sure that'll give you enough time to, like,
make notes.
Put your thoughts in order.
Yeah. So.
I just finished my drawing as well.
You'll have to show me tomorrow, because, I need to sleep.
Go to bed.
I'll rewatch this in the morning. Anyway, so I shall say thank you, Dante, for watching. I have closed out of the stream, or not the stream, the video, so I cannot see what you're typing. So don't try.
Thank you. Why? Hoshikuse say Air-lies.
That's not how we're ending this. Anyway, but yeah.
Okay.
I gotta go sleep. This is the closest my phone's been to dead. Oh, wait, sorry. I'm failing at Instagram. Anyway, have a good night.